Twitter from its platform, along with the category parties and events allowed. Ginny Cosella, Fox News.
A British study finds singing is no more risky than speaking when it comes to the possibility of spreading COVID-19, but scientists say volume is the most important risk factor. Scientists at the University of Bristol looked at the amount of droplets generated by 25 professional singers who did singing, breathing, speaking, and coughing exercises. It found the number of droplets increased with the loudness of singing by as much as 30 times, but singing didn't produce more droplets than speaking at a similar volume. The study has not yet been peer-reviewed. I'm Lee Silicera. This is Fox News.
Congress today passed a landmark Social Security reform bill they estimate could save the troubled program billions. The so-called Grab Life by the Balls bill includes provisions to cut the cost of cigarettes in half, outlaws helmets, and adjusts the CDC's recommended amount of sleep from 8 hours a night to when you're dead. The bill's short-term initiatives aim to immediately cut Social Security costs in half by replacing senior citizens' monthly checks with vouchers for grain, alcohol, and extreme sports.
I got this coupon to motocross over a canyon. Better do my part to help the deficit.
Supporters in Congress say the cost will be offset by the so-called pussy tax on products such as sweaters, vegetables, hand soap, and flu shots.
America, would you rather die old, broke, and forgotten, or die a motherfucking legend?
The new program follows in the footsteps of the Life is a Cartoon Medicare campaign, which encourages seniors to run full speed off of cliffs and smoke sticks of dynamite.
This is the Onion News Network.
It's Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll free. Take control of the airwaves. 855-450-FREE like freedom. That's 855-450-3733. We have in the studio with you tonight, it's Ian.
And Tyler.
And Mark.
Of course, we'll take your calls about anything you want to discuss. Starting out, though, tonight, Mark, you had a disturbing but not surprising story about what happened to one student when his teacher snitched him out with this at-home learning thing going on.
Yeah, and in this case, she wouldn't have ever had the opportunity had it not been for the online learning at home.
Mm-hmm.
Teacher spying on student. This is from pjmedia.com. Paula Bolliard reporting. Teacher spying on student during virtual class sends cops to search 11-year-old home. 11-year-old's home.
Well, I don't know if you can call it spying when you voluntarily choose to have a video feed coming from your room that anyone who's within the government can access, especially the teacher. I don't think you can call that spying, but I guess she was spying things
it's
in the
nosy.
Background. She was seeing things in the background, right?
Yep. Not minding her own
Not
business,
minding
certainly.
Her own business, yeah.
A Baltimore County, Maryland fifth grader.
Baltimore, okay.
Got a visit from the police after his teacher called to report that she had seen a BB gun on the wall behind the student during a class video call. The boy's mother, Courtney Lancaster Sperry.
Now, I'm not sure how she knew it was a BB gun. Was
I'm
she
not
a,
sure
able
that,
to identify
I, the... Well, that's it's not in quotes, mm-hmm. right? So I don't know what right. they. She saw something.
She
and
thought
they identified
it was a gun,
his, right.
probably.
It was a gun, right?
Yeah.
Not a firearm, but a gun.
Mm-hmm.
The boy's mother, Courtney Lancaster Sperry, a Navy veteran,
well, how about that?
is warning other parents about a lack of privacy during virtual classes after her son was targeted by a teacher who saw that she was what she thought was a scary-looking gun hanging on the wall of the boy's bedroom. Well, my son was on a Zoom call. A concerned parent and subsequently two teachers saw his properly stowed and mounted Red Ryder BB gun. And
that's one of the classics, right? The Red Ryder?
Yep.
I had a Red Ryder.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Yeah.
Put your eye
was
eye
it a pump? Was
kid.
It a pump?
Yeah.
Well, it's a lever action.
Yeah, right. lever.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep. You have no CO2 cartridge or nothing.
But it's air pumped.
Yep.
With a
yep.
lever.
Yep. yep.
How many times could you pump it?
Oh, no, just once. Actually, just I don't think... it wasn't air pumped. I think it was a spring. The
okay.
lever The lever reset the spring. It was
okay.
spring.
Yeah. I see. So... pretty weak.
Yeah.
I had a Crossman 880.
Mm-hmm.
You could put 10 pumps into this thing.
Nice.
And, you know, kill whatever varmints you
yep.
needed to kill. They're still great for that, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can't be in your out in your neighborhood plugging things with a .22 rifle, but...
So how old is this kid again?
He's a fifth grader. He's 11.
11. Okay. Yeah. 11. BB gun. That's
definitely
not bad.
Old enough for a BB
I got
gun.
My first 22, you know, at 11.
At 11.
Okay. Yeah. That you could keep in your room?
That I kept in my room, wow. And I kept my own ammunition. I mean, granted, I grew up out in the farm or out on a farm. I'm not sure where
But that doesn't make you less likely to shoot yourself. I mean,
no, it definitely doesn't.
The genetics of a kid who grows up on the farm is no different than the genetics of a kid in suburbia.
No, but I can see how in suburbia a kid might have a BB gun at 11. You know, he can use that in the backyard. But yeah, that's not an unreasonable age for a kid to
not
have a BB
all.
Gun at all.
We, I mean, my dad kept his rifle in the closet.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the closet wasn't locked. I was just told, that's dad's gun. You don't get to use that one.
Right.
And that was that.
Yeah. I mean, my dad never had a gun safe either. It was just a matter of, like, don't touch things that you don't know about. And we were taught at a young age, like, these are firearms. These are deadly. Handle these correctly. You know? But at a certain age, too, you're also taught, it's like, hey, if somebody comes in the house and you're the only one here, you need to know where these are.
Yeah, that conversation was never had in my house, but I suspect it would have been fine. Let's see. And another BB gun in the background. He was not holding them and never intentionally showed them on video. In fact, he was oblivious.
Didn't think anything of it.
Yeah, that they're even in the
background.
They're
always there. So.
Right? It's just his BB gun.
Yep.
And it's just a decoration on the wall till he needs it. After the teacher reported the gun, the principal, Jason something, Failer, decided to call the police to report the guns and ask that the home be searched. The principal and the teacher, imagine, ladies and gentlemen, right now, if you're a veteran and a gun owner and a parent, the police, the principal of your school, supposed to be educating your child, has the police called on you to have your house searched. According to this article, the principal called to have the house searched, not to report that they had seen something that looked like a gun. It could have been, you know, anything. It could have been a replica, could have been a real gun, could have been a BB gun, could have been, you know, whatever. Airsoft rifle. Because, you know, this is the problem with people who are ignoramuses surrounding firearms having...
What school was it?
It was in Maryland County.
I understand that. You said it was Baltimore County, I think, in Maryland.
Yeah, Baltimore County.
Does it say what the name of the school was, though?
This kid's got a nice arsenal set up, actually. He's got, like, a nice gun rack on his wall.
I'm curious if it was...
some pegboard, yeah.
Yeah.
He's got a bow and arrow.
Not bad.
What I'm curious about was this the city of Baltimore, or was this...
Baltimore County, Maryland is what it says, a fifth grader. That's what I got for you.
Okay, so it doesn't say the school. Gotcha.
Right.
Okay.
Not that I've got here. I mean, I'm sure I could hunt around for it, but that wasn't a question I was anticipating.
Does the article go on to say that the police showed up to their house? Does that actually happen?
Yeah.
Or?
Yeah. Yeah.
Because I'm just wondering, at what point in this chain of events did somebody snap in and go, why is this even being pursued? What law was broken?
Oh, I have the reason right here.
Okay.
The principal and the teacher cited a rule stating that students may not bring guns to school. Yeah. And claim that extended to virtual classes as well.
Out of here. That is ridiculous.
That's why I said this is not surprising.
Your house now belongs to the county school.
Yeah.
I saw an article today that also said somewhere parents are being given forms to sign saying that they're not going to watch in on their child while they're learning.
Really?
Apparently the teacher's afraid of being spied on now by the parents. And they want to be left to teach.
Because now you can audit. Now you can actually audit a class.
Right.
Before, you'd have to sit in there, and of course, then everybody's going to pay attention to you. And it's
have never in my lifetime seen a parent in
audit
a class.
Yeah.
Now, admittedly, I've only been in the classes I've been in, but I went to 13 years of them. Sperry told PJ Media that the school's vice principal called her ex-husband, claiming to be checking on network connectivity. She believes the real reason for the call was to find out whose house her son was at. The vice principal ended the call without leveraging the opportunity to discuss the matter, or rather was fishing for information to find out where to dispatch the police. The 11-year-old in question is a Boy Scout, pursuing the rank of Eagle Scout, is an outdoors all-boy kind of kid, his mother said, and his parents, and by way of legal rights, he is allowed to own said guns. In addition to the BB gun, she said her son is training in archery and enjoys shooting the airsoft gun.
Well, okay, so I went and I looked the story up, Mark, and I found that it is Seneca Elementary School? I guess, he would still be in elementary school at that age, yeah. So Seneca Elementary School, which is sort of over by the waterfront, there. There's like some water to the east of Baltimore, and it's sort of that direction. It definitely is part of what appears to be a metro area of Baltimore, but somewhat on the outskirts of it. And the reason why I'm asking about where this is because there's a story from 2016 that the Baltimore City Council actually banned BB guns and any replica firearms from within city limits. So, you know,
a citywide ban?
Yeah.
How could you even do that?
Yeah.
Because they can do it.
Because it hasn't been disputed, probably.
Well, I mean, it's the government. I mean, they kind of do whatever it is they want to do. In this case, of course, they're using the excuse that they're protecting the city's youth 5 months after police officers shot a 14-year-old in the shoulder and the leg on a street in East Baltimore. The young man was carrying a BB gun that officers said resembled a semi-automatic pistol. Quote, it's something that we should do for the safety of our children, said the city council president. Meaning the safety of their children from getting shot by the police.
Right.
Right.
We're getting stores robbed with replicas. We've got people running around with these things, and they almost look real. I don't think we should be allowing replica guns in the city of Baltimore, especially with the murder rate we have. So no, in Baltimore, you cannot have BB guns, air rifles, and pellet guns. $250 fine for the first offense, $1,000 fine for subsequent offenses. Repeat offenders who are caught more than twice will face misdemeanor charge. And maximum 30 days in jail.
This goes on. Now we will get to talk to the cops.
Great. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can take control of the airwaves. Bring up whatever's on your mind. This is Free Talk Live.
Maxwell, he was a runaway into rescue, great disposition. About 9 years ago, he was scratching a lot, and he started losing some hair. My vet, she says, oh, he must be allergic to the chicken. Another vet says, it's the grain. Third vet, she says, it's the weather, something in the air. And then somebody said,
VINOVITE.com.
I have been listening to these Dynavite ads, hearing about different stories of different people, and it just clicked. I got my first 90-day supply, and it took a grand total of 2 weeks. And the dog stopped itching, the hair stopped falling out.
Dynavite is nutrition.
And Maxwell loved it. Now he's close to 10. And the Dynavite's a big part of Maxwell's diet.
Dynavite for life.
You won't believe how happy your dog will be.
And he's a spectacular dog.
DINOVITE.com.
Divvy's been a pretty good investment for Free Talk Live. Their ad campaign started in September 2019, and from mid-March to mid-July, the values soared by 10 times. It's not too late. Divvy's new wallet hasn't even released yet, and other things are happening that I can't even say on the radio. If you want to invest and potentially do well, go to DivvyProject.org. I can tell you that FTL is deepening its partnership with the guys from DivvyProject.org. Past performance is not an indication of future profit. DivvyProject.org. D-I-V-I Project.org. News from news.bitcoin.com. Chinese banks limit customers' ability to buy gold. Chinese flooding and potential dam collapse threatens many Bitcoin operations. Withdrawals from crypto exchanges increase, indicating perhaps more people are holding their coin for themselves. Tentative agreement met to stabilize Bitcoin Cash mining in conjunction with the currency's third birthday. Bitcoin.com is your source for getting started with cryptocurrencies, getting a wallet, buying Bitcoin Cash, mining, and all the latest cryptocurrency news at news.bitcoin.com.
This is Michael Dean from the Freedom Fiends. I've run websites since 1996 and have used over a dozen web hosts in that time. AgristHosting.com is the only one that hasn't broken my heart. Agrist Hosting's uptime and service is stellar, and their DDoS mitigation is the best I've seen. That's important because if you tell the truth in this world, you'll ruffle feathers. And some people will try dirty tricks to silence your voice. No matter what the haters hit us with, Agrist Hosting keeps our websites online. If you have a mission-critical commercial presence or a world-changing activism site, you cannot tolerate any skullduggery. So go with agristhosting.com. Have a WordPress or blog site, but you're not satisfied with performance or uptime? Or just want raw hosting? Want to pay with Bitcoin? Agrist Hosting specializes in high-performance hosting with personalized service. Go to agristhosting.com and click on the button that says Get Hosted. That's agristhosting.com.
LRN.fm now has a Discord.
Discord is a free text and voice chat platform, and we now have our own server with a bunch of channels at discord.lrn.fm. You can join other listeners as they chat about various things during our live shows, or anytime, day or night. Discord software is available cross-platform, so you can have it on whatever device you want and take your chats anywhere. Join our Discord at discord.lrn.fm. That's discord.lrn.fm. So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
Some of our live shows are streamed in HD on Twitch. Please follow and share at twitch.lrn.fm. That's twitch.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can bring up whatever you want here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We're talking about a disturbing story involving this so-called new normal, where young people are now staying home in a lot of cases, but still going to government schools. And surprise, when you let the government into your bedroom, they're going to get into your business.
It's amazing.
And that's what is happening here, which is why I said earlier that this wasn't a surprising story. Completely predictable. But now a young man who is a Boy Scout is now facing, I don't know, we haven't gotten to the criminal charges or what the punishment has been yet, but at the very least had his house searched by the police in Baltimore County, Maryland. We can talk more about it. Your calls are welcome as well at 855-450-FREE. And Free Talk Live is brought to you by Freedom's Phoenix, a liberty-oriented news aggregation site. If you want the newest and freshest stories and perspectives on current events from those who value liberty, freedomsphoenix.com has them, and they've got a daily dispatch where you can stay up to date on science, technology, historical findings, liberty news, government overspending, and the rise of the police state. Go to freedomswithanSphoenix.com, freedomsphoenix.com. Mark, we'll get back into your story coming up here in a moment, but first, let's go to the phones to your calls and thoughts. Jonathan is in South Carolina. You're on Free Talk Live. Go ahead, Jonathan. Hello, Jonathan.
Mark looks like a fucking penguin.
No, you can't say that on the radio. All right, so we continue. 855-450-FREE. Mark, let's go on with your story. What's the latest on what's going on?
Well, let me go on with what happened. So the teachers and the prince that well,
teacher snitches out the student for having a BB
gun. Concerned parents snitched to the teacher. The teacher then
concerned parents. Okay, gotcha. So other parents saw the gun.
This
on the back
also
wall.
Then brought it to the attention. The teacher sees it. Principal is involved. The principal calls the police in order to have the house searched, and that's kind of where we're at.
Now, didn't you say the principal wasn't sure which house to search? Was it the parents were divorced or something?
Right. So they were checking out which house to go.
So they figured it out somehow?
Right.
Okay.
So I answered the door. This is the mom. The police officer was very nice. He explained to me that he was coming to my address to address an issue with my son's school. And then explained to me that he was here to search for weapons in my home. And I consented to let him in.
Whoops. Two mistakes. And one, then, answering the door. Two, consenting to a search. Go on.
Well, I understand answering the door when the police come because you're never entirely sure what they're there for.
I get it.
Yeah.
But they're usually there to investigate you.
But she could have just as easily said, there's something on the stove that's burning. Excuse me. Blam. And close the door and not come back.
Yeah, that's true.
And then I unfortunately stood there and watched police officers enter my 11-year-old son's bedroom. Mm. The officers that responded were appalled at the call and even commended the setup that my son has for his toys and commended him also on his respect and understanding of the BB guns.
Isn't that nice?
Yeah, this is super interesting because that's what I was wondering. I was waiting for the part where somebody up this chain stopped and goes, guys, this doesn't make any sense. Why is this even an issue? Like, but these guys still went and enforced this order that they were given and just complained about it the whole time. And that's not how you handle that situation, in my opinion.
That's not what a moral person would do. They would say, oh, we should just go away. This is ridiculous.
Right. We should just drop this nonsense.
But that's not the way government works. And I saw that recently right out here in front of the studio. There was a law enforcement officer here in Keene, New Hampshire, who came by the other day. I'm not going to say which one it was because of the content of the conversation. I'm actually trying to protect this guy. But he came by and said he's sick and tired of government overreach. It's gone too far. I think it was the mask ordinance that pushed him over the edge. And, you know, we went back and forth and he was being super friendly or whatever. And then he revealed that the reason why he's there is because somebody on the street keeps calling them. Because somebody is blowing, you know, every now and then somebody blows through the stop sign here. It's a three-way intersection, so there's two of the ways that are busier than the other way. And the straight way gets people blowing through the stop sign. So somebody's been calling them. So he was actually there to pull somebody over if he saw him go through the stop sign. And sure enough, somebody goes through the stop sign and he pulls him over, even though he admits to me in the conversation that the stop signs don't belong there.
Really?
Yeah, frankly, yes, I don't think those two belong that you're referring to belong there.
He agreed. I
mean, you know.
And then he went and pulled somebody over for it.
Right, well, yeah.
So
did
it's
he
like,
give him a ticket?
I didn't get down there to observe that. A lot of times they just do warnings here in Keene, actually New Hampshire in general.
Yeah, I think moving violations in the state of New Hampshire, the money goes to the state, which means
so
that
the local
cops don't really see any value from it, and it's not the fundraising tool that many police departments around the country use.
But my
point was other departments should look at that, and frankly, I think it should be stepped up that if this is about safety, the money should be given to charities, not to any government agency.
The point, though, is that he was of two simultaneous minds, or if you could even call the other one a mind. There was the mind of the man that said, "God, there's no need for these stop signs." Mm-hmm. And then there's the bureaucrat, this automaton cop who's like doing what he's told to do.
Right. And I don't get paid enough to think about it that much. You know, that's a mentality a lot of these guys have.
He also mentioned to me, I shouldn't say this, but at some point he's going to retire. I'm not going to say how soon that retirement is coming, but you know, obviously he doesn't want to rock the boat or anything like that. He's got a retirement coming up.
Right.
And he'll get
90%
of his paycheck or whatever for the rest of his life.
Yep.
Which, you know, you can't blame somebody for wanting to get a piece of that action.
Especially when you've been doing it this long, you know. Yeah.
Right.
Yep.
It's good money.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the mindset, is they do what they're told.
According to the lady here, Miss Berry, the officers were more than nice. Although they did not have a warrant, I have always been taught to not only comply, but that I had nothing to hide and was and allowed them to look wherever they wanted
to. Well, that is false. Please stop teaching people that because that is statist propaganda that gives the police the permission, because she gave them permission, to search her home with the belief that she had nothing to hide. Now, again, if she was in Baltimore proper, she's violated the ban on BB guns. And so technically she did have that to hide. And who knows what else you have to hide that you don't think you have to hide that's illegal that you don't know is illegal. You don't know what all the laws are.
Well,
and they don't either, mind you, but they certainly know some of the ones that you don't know, and they could be finding other violations as they're looking through your stuff.
She got lucky here, I think. I think she got some good cops that were only intending there to look for the thing that they came to look for. And
well, I wouldn't call those good cops. Okay, because they still wasted this woman's time. They made her feel probably somewhat intimidated and frightened. So that is not a good thing what those men did. Now, if you're saying they're good because they didn't also take a baseball bat to the inside of her home and smash up all of her, you know, precious vases or china or whatever, then okay, they weren't as bad as they could have been. They didn't rape her, apparently, while they were there.
Well, it certainly happened as far as police officers go, but I would say that you know, like, I imagine these police feel like in around Baltimore, where they have outlawed BB guns, that they probably have to go and check out calls on 11-year-olds with ARs. And that's what it looks like. It's got the red tip on the front. But nonetheless, I'm not here to defend the police officers. What I wanted to do was read this little part where she says that looking at the fear on her son's face.
Yeah, not a good
made
thing.
Her feel violated as the police went through his room.
Yeah, not good cops.
Right. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm not claiming they're good cops.
You did earlier. You can take it back.
Here's I'm not going to take it back. What I'm going to take what I'm going to say is that whatever the police are in this case is paled in comparison by the officious bureaucrats that you send your children to school to deal with every single day.
The toll-free, but if the cops wouldn't have listened, if the cops were like, yeah, leave that kid alone, then...
Look, I get it. They're not the good paladins of liberty that you wish they were.
Okay? Then they would have been good. Instead, they terrorized this poor kid.
They don't give libertarians jobs in police departments.
That's 855-450-3733. That's actually not true. There's supposedly one of them in the police chief area here.
Do you want more businesses accepting Bitcoin Cash and Dash? Now with AnyPay, you earn passive income for every purchase at those businesses. Finally, a financial incentive to spread Bitcoin Cash and Dash. You made it happen, so you get the rewards. Download the AnyPay Cash Register app and add your cryptocurrency wallet addresses. Then install it at a real-life business and tell us what you did at AnyPayInc.com. AnyPayInc.com.
News from news.bitcoin.com. Chinese banks limit customers' ability to buy gold. Chinese flooding and potential dam collapse threatens many Bitcoin operations. Withdrawals from crypto exchanges increase, indicating perhaps more people are holding their coin for themselves. Tentative agreement met to stabilize Bitcoin Cash mining in conjunction with the currency's third birthday. Bitcoin.com is your source for getting started with cryptocurrencies, getting a wallet, buying Bitcoin Cash, mining, and all the latest cryptocurrency news at news.bitcoin.com.
We have some good news. The indictments against Ross Ulbricht in the District of Maryland were dismissed with prejudice, meaning they can never be refiled. This is especially good because those indictments contain the only charge ever made that Ross engaged in murder for hire. This was a serious allegation that Ross Ulbricht denies. It was never prosecuted or ruled on by a jury, but was trumpeted by the federal government and the media as if it were proven fact. The Maryland court held these indictments for almost 5 years, poisoning Ross's case and leaving him under a cloud of unproven allegations. As explained in Ross's appeal to the Supreme Court, the fact that the judge used these allegations to give Ross a draconian sentence of double life without parole violated his Sixth Amendment right to a jury trial. Judges are required to issue sentences based on convictions decided by a jury, not unproven allegations, never even charged at trial. Although this is a positive development, the dropped indictment will not set Ross free. Now, a presidential pardon is Ross's only hope of freedom. Sign the petition at FreeRoss.org. FreeRoss.org.
The new fourth edition of Healing Our World, The Compassion of Libertarianism, will take your understanding of liberty to a deeper level and has over 1,300 updated references, new cartoons, and a foreword by Dr. Ron Paul. With discounts for multiple book purchases, the fourth edition of Healing Our World is a great gift for the liberals, pragmatists, environmentalists, and Christians in your life who think libertarianism is cold-hearted. Get yours today at healing.freetalklive.com and use promo code FTL for a $5 discount. The LRN.FM social media channels have been revamped. We've eliminated Facebook and focused on other platforms like Twitter and Mastodon, the decentralized alternative to Twitter. On our accounts, you'll find posts from multiple LRN.FM show hosts together in one place. Follow us on Twitter at twitter.lrn.fm, or better yet, move to the decentralized Mastodon social media platform at toot.lrn.fm, toot.lrn.fm. I think you'll like it.
It's the video sensation that's taking the internet by storm. A web series on YouTube passed the 100 views mark this week. Titled Andrew and John, the wildly popular webisodes feature roommates Andrew Vanier and John Haney playing fictionalized versions of themselves in unusual situations, mostly set in and around their Chicago apartment.
Dude, did you get my tart?
What's a tart?
Oh, you just texted me a fart.
Their latest short titled Laundry Day reached the unprecedented 100 view milestone this week after a heavy promotional push in which the duo posted the skits to their Facebook pages. The hit video features the roommates wearing unconventional outfits while scrounging up enough change to do laundry in their basement. Other popular episodes include Foreign Landlord featuring John's friend Brett from work and a video where Andrew suspects John might be a zombie.
Our videos consistently get over 50 views now, but Laundry Day, that's the first one that's really taken off.
Yeah, everyone I know has seen it.
It's completely viral.
This is the Onion News Network.
Love what we do? Please help support our international satellite channels at patreon.lrn.fm. That's patreon.lrn.fm.
It It's Free Talk Live. Dial in, toll free, bring up whatever you want here. The number for you, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got more about this, 11-year-old who had a BB gun mounted on the wall behind him while he was in his online class in the Baltimore County, Maryland area. And the teacher sent the police to his house, and his room got tossed by the cops in a search.
Well, I don't know if tossed is the right terminology here.
You think they just went in and glanced around?
They did not complain about the condition of the room afterwards. So, and the cops complimented him on his setup, mm-hmm. the way he had the guns on the wall stored and the ammunition stored separately and all that stuff.
I bet you they went through his drawers. They went through his closet.
I don't know what to say about that.
Yeah, they went to search his house, right? They went to search for guns.
If they saw
they're
the
not
guns
just go in and
that the teachers
around.
Looked for, mm-hmm. and they found those guns, right. and those guns were BB guns.
I can't believe you're actually attributing to the police the idea that they wouldn't go and search a place that they believed that they had the right to search.
All
due
I'm
to
saying
being
is
given
you
permission.
Have no evidence.
So, Ian, I'm with you, right? I think these cops are the way they should have handled it if they were good cops is they would have like gone to their supervisor and been like, this is ridiculous. I'm not doing it.
Right.
Right.
We
that
got better things to do.
Right. Right. But that's not what happened. Here's the thing, though. I don't think they're the worst people in this story. And the focus needs to be on these school administrators. Right. Because the first thing that they did wrong was that they're so out of touch with America that they have no understanding of gun culture. Right. This kid's mm-hmm. a Boy Scout. Being a Boy Scout includes marksmanship. Like, that's yep. part of becoming a Boy Scout. And sure. if you want to make something like that illegal, that's just talking about like, let's just erase the fabric of America. Secondly, they didn't talk to the parent first. I don't know why they went to the police. Like, why didn't they just
it's
go, hey.
It's not their policy.
What? It's not their policy?
That's literally what the principal said.
So they just want.
Look, you don't understand. Somebody
when
could
the
get
mother
hurt.
Demanded to see the screenshot taken by the creeper teachers, she was told that she would not be allowed to view it because it wasn't part of his official school record. Let's see.
I'm sorry, ma'am. That case is still being investigated. We can't share that evidence with you.
Yeah. There's a part in here where they say that, why didn't they just call me and talk about it? But, you know, whatever.
Public schools encourage snitching, right? Mm-hmm. If you get in a fight in a public school as a kid, it doesn't matter if you started the fight or not. You still get suspended. You get sent home. And the teachers will tell you, don't fight, just come get an adult. And then you breed that mentality into normal people. And these teachers and these parents all decide that snitching's okay. And then we get to this situation where a kid's being harassed by the police over something that, like, is as American as anything else, you know. And these people are so out of touch, and they just think that it's a bad thing. I don't understand it.
I've explained to my son that he did nothing wrong, Sperry said. Mm-hmm. He said, I'm just sad because I thought the teachers were my friends. This is an Eagle Scout, ladies and gentlemen.
Good lesson to learn early.
Yeah, really.
Right. These are the most upstanding young men America produces for generations. And they have just had. Remember what the Boy Scouts does. Mm-hmm. The Boy Scouts is a preparatory camp for getting kids to join the military and be the sort of, you know, mm-hmm. strong, young, greatest generation kind of kid. And they just broke that in an 11-year-old kid. They just taught an 11-year-old kid, you can't trust your government because your teacher, instead of looking at the weapon and saying, hey, oh, nice setup or whatever, because kids used to carry BB guns, used to carry 22 rifles to school.
Long time ago. Before my time.
I bet you it was going on somewhere in America within your lifetime.
Maybe.
Imagine getting red-pilled as an 11-year-old over a BB gun.
Yep.
This kid's going to become like a Second Amendment lobbyist faster than
The yeah. school refused to comment on the specific case, but told Fox Baltimore, there are multiple ways for families to share concerns with us. In general terms, the safety of students and staff is our chief concern, whether we are in meeting in classrooms or via continuing continuity learning. So, you know, basically, we'll do what we want. Screw you. So what are the Sperry wants to know, what are the parameters? Where are the lines drawn? If my son's sitting in the kitchen island next to a butcher block, does that constitute a weapon? It's not allowed in school, right? I presume she's talking about the knife sitting on the butcher block.
Yeah.
So would you? So would my home be searched because he's sitting next to a butcher block? I feel like parents need to be made aware of what the implications are and what the expectations are. Virtual learning may work well for you, she said.
Let me make you aware. Here are the implications. If you let the government into your home virtually, they believe they have the right to go in there physically. That's it.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. You should have known in advance. And hopefully now you'll know, again, I'm not a lawyer, this is not legal advice, but it's my understanding that if the cops come to your home, unless they have a warrant, then any kind of search that's performed is done generally with your permission. And if it's not done with your permission, hopefully you can get video of that happening and of you denying them permission if they haven't already taken you into custody.
Yeah, I would really like the police in this circumstance to have said, excuse me, ma'am, we're here to, we've been gotten a call about your son having a gun. And apparently it was seen in an online photo of him in school. We would like to search his room, but I would first like to advise you. You can tell us no. In fact, you can tell us to get off your porch and
again,
leave.
What an actual good cop or a
that
better
be
cop might
who,
do.
That would be somebody who respected their oath to the Constitution, might say.
Right.
One last thing here, Sperry, the mom says, virtual learning may work well for you, but make sure nothing in your home offends anyone, or you may spend the next couple of weeks circumventing the invasion and violation that I did today. My child in my home will no longer be subjected to video to allow room for any other violation of my rights and how I legally manage my home, she declared.
So ultimately, she wasn't charged with anything, huh?
As best I could tell, no.
Did they even confiscate the BB guns?
No. Not there's no evidence
that they should have,
tossed the room or took the BB guns or anything like that.
Well, if you want to comment, you're welcome to join us here, 855-450-FREE. If you believe that this is totally fine and that students should expect to have regular visits from the police just to make sure they're not harboring any fun things, then give us a call. The toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Dave in New Hampshire. He's Dave Ridley from RidleyReport.com. Go ahead, Dave.
Gentlemen, remember that video I got back in 2018 where Keene State College tried to prevent me from filming a City of Keene government meeting?
Yeah, it was a City of Keene government meeting that, if I recall correctly, was happening for some reason on the college campus instead of the City of Keene building. And
bigger venue?
And some goon from the security squad got in your way.
Yeah, it was the thing called the City College meeting or the College City meeting. Okay. I can't remember which. Or City College Commission, something like that. But it was both the Keene State College and the city government. They sometimes have the meeting on campus. Sometimes they have the meeting at Keene City Hall. But yeah, they, you know, the security lost their minds and they called the cops and the cops ejected me from the university grounds because I refused to identify myself. I just wanted to film.
Sure.
So,
which is
anyway, I have an update. I have an update on Keene State College censorship.
Okay, let's hear it, because we've covered what they're doing recently with the reopening, and it's absolutely ridiculous, not allowing students to hug each other or shake
hands. No hugging.
There shall be no partying, apparently.
No touching. Do not touch the girls.
Yeah. No fun.
Yeah, no fun allowed. All right, so what else is going on, Dave?
At least that'll help keep people. Maybe that'll help keep people out of college. But
it may very well. In fact, I know Tyler is planning on doing the remote courses. You are a student at that college.
Yep, I'm a student there. Doing the whole thing remote this semester. Don't have to go in once. Hopefully.
So what's
as
up,
I
Dave?
Was as I was looking over the COVID restrictions that they have posted on keene.edu, I noticed that there are apparently some pre-existing restrictions that are even more disturbing. That I didn't know about before, but apparently students, when they're brought up on disciplinary hearings or code of conduct hearings, they are not allowed to record the hearings.
Oh my.
And additionally, media is not allowed to even enter the hearing.
Closed.
This is on a government
court.
This is a government campus. It's
stand by, Dave Ridley with us here from RidleyReport.com. Our number is 855-450. Free like freedom. You can take control of the airwaves here. It's Free Talk Live.
tech. Have you ever thought about turning your Glock, XD family, or 1911 handgun into a semi-automatic carbine? It only takes about 30 seconds. The MechTech Carbine Upper is classified as an accessory and can be delivered right to your doorstep with no FFL or background check required. It's the world's most versatile pistol accessory. Build your custom upper today. Simply go to handgunconversion.com. That's handgunconversion.com.
Attention radio listeners. Have you ever wanted to be independent of the utility companies and actually generate your own supply of off-grid electrical power? If so, this is going to be the most important message you'll ever hear. Here's why. A limited number of solar-powered backup generators are back in stock and now available. These emergency backup systems provide life-saving electrical power when you need it most. And unlike gas generators, a solar generator runs quietly, emits no fumes, and produces an endless supply of free electricity from the sun. It's like having an electric power plant running silently, secretly, in your own home. Run sump pumps, shortwave radios, computers, even keep food from spoiling. Go to mysolarbackup.com to learn more. That's mysolarbackup.com. Supplies are still limited and are available on a first-come, first-served basis only. MySolarBackup.com.
Are you afraid to go to the mailbox because of letter after letter from the IRS? Are they stacking on more and more penalties and interest? By now, you know the problem won't go away on its own. Don't let the IRS chase you to your grave with penalties and interest and liens and levies. You need real help now. I'm Dan Pilla. I wrote the book on tax debt settlement, and I help thousands of people solve tax problems they thought couldn't be solved. I can help you too. Call 800-34-NO-TAX or go to my website, danpilla.com. That's danpilla.com. Danpilla.com.
A congressman recently revealed that legislation totaling 2,900 pages and involving more than $1 trillion was available to members of Congress for less than 48 hours to study and consider. That's over 60 pages of legislation per hour. You think anyone read the entire bill? I'm Jim Babka with DownsizeDC.org. Consider a proposal buried in a 3,200-page, $388 billion bill, which would have empowered committee chairmen or their agents to examine Americans' tax returns. When this horrible provision came to light, no one claimed to know how it got into the bill. One congressman questioned said, "I didn't write it, I didn't approve it, I wasn't even consulted." If your attorney represented you this way, he might be disbarred. But this is how Congress represents you every day. That's why DownsizeDC.org has created the Read the Bills Act. You can force Congress to read their bills before they pass them at DownsizeDC.org.
There are lots of ways to listen to Free Talk Live. Our podcast has been around since podcasts began, and now the FTL feed is loaded with content besides our full show archives. Did you know that we make it easy for you to customize your podcast subscriptions? We have different feeds, one that includes only our full shows, one with just the Daily Digest, and our main feed that includes everything. You decide what you listen to. It's quick and easy to customize your feeds at feeds.freetalklive.com. That's feeds.freetalklive.com.
Cell 411 is a free app for Android and iOS that replaces government-controlled 911. Cell 411 allows you to preset a group of friends or private organizations to show up at any emergency. Cell 411 is a nightmare for the state because it proves their so-called services aren't needed. Cell 411 has had thousands of installs, and of course it's covered by the BIPCOT no government license. Cell 411 because your friends won't shoot you when you're in trouble. Without the government, who would build the emergency services? You and Cell 411. Get it today at getcell411.com.
Now you can follow LRN.FM on the decentralized Mastodon social media platform at toot.lrn.fm, toot.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free, bring up what you want. Number's 855-450-FREE. We're talking about some very disturbing school-related news. You got a teacher in Baltimore turning one of his own students in. Or her own students in.
Yeah, I don't know the gender of the teacher.
Sending the police to the young man's home in order to conduct a search for BB guns that were seen in the background of a video during this remote learning. So also, we got an update on what sort of madness has been going on college campuses as Dave Ridley is joining us. We're going to get back into his call. And, of course, your thoughts are welcome. Our number is 855-450-FREE like freedom. That's 855-450-3733. Let's go back to Dave on our Discord lines. Go ahead, Dave.
Yes, so I was talking about how you're not allowed to record your own hearing when you are a student brought up on a code of conduct violation at Keene State College.
Is this true at all colleges or just Keene State?
I bet you it's pretty standard. That's just normally they're using boilerplate, right? They copied from some other college.
It wouldn't surprise me.
The college does record it, but they destroy the recordings within 30 days after making the recordings, I guess. Mm-hmm. So they suppress the evidence. If they've done something badly, they can, do like the cops do sometimes when they have body cam and they've done something wrong.
Yep.
They just, delete the video because they shot it, but you can't.
So,
but the other thing.
So before you go on with the other thing, on these college campuses, in order to go to the college, you are told you have to sign an agreement. And part of that agreement, and I don't know, Tyler, since you're going to the very same school, if they treat you differently as somebody who's not living on campus. But I know, for instance, the students, at the very least, that are living on campus have to sign an agreement saying that they will consent to having their rooms
whatever
searched.
Sort of make-believe justice these people whip up, apparently.
So if the students or the school security wants to come search their room, they have to consent. And if they want to stop them, I believe, on any of the college campus paths or wherever, like anywhere outside, and want to search them outside, I believe they have to consent to that. Do you know if being an off-campus student, you also have consented to any on-campus searches?
No, I don't believe so. I mean, the way it was written when I consented to go in online is I had to commit to going online completely. Like, I'm not going to go on campus at all this semester.
But I meant like before... previously.
Maybe last year.
Yeah.
I never considered it when I went on campus. No one ever told me that they were allowed to go through my bag or anything like that. And
did
I was
you
under,
sign a, an
I'd never signed anything that said that. Interesting. That I can recall. Okay. No.
You probably signed an agreement that says I'm going
to
be a student.
Yeah. To be fair, I joined the Navy, so I signed a lot of papers without reading them.
So. Yeah. Okay. It's probably in there somewhere. But anyway, go ahead, Dave, with the rest. So that's part of it, right? When you sign that agreement, you're also agreeing to waive any kind of a right to a public hearing. That's in there. That's got to be in there. It's like, yeah, okay. Well, if there's disciplinary actions, you don't get to record them. Sign here. You want to be educated? You got to agree.
Right? Yeah. That's it.
That's it.
So. I was able to confront the president of the university about this on live
college,
talk radio
university.
on the Keene radio station. However, they cut me off just as she was beginning to answer. and so all I heard was her say, well, we treasure students' rights and then I didn't hear anything after that.
Oh, so you weren't able to actually listen to the broadcast after you hung up?
Well, I mean, that's complicated. You got to punch a bunch of buttons and find out what URL. Where do I go?
It's probably that she dodged the question. That's just going to be my guess, given that she's a politician. So, I mean, she's the president of a college, a political position. Knowing that, she's probably just put a bunch of words out into the air without saying anything, like politicians are so good at.
Yeah.
I did notice another COVID restriction that was interesting, though, while I was looking at the COVID restrictions. And that was that apparently students are, in practice, maybe accidentally banned from eating while standing up outside.
Eating while standing up outside. Can you explain how that restriction came into play and what do you think it has to do with?
So the way it's worded is, quote, they're saying that they will, quote, wear a mask at all times on campus except when in my residence hall room, off-campus living spaces, or eating while seated, unquote.
I see.
Wow.
So you can't eat and walk. Yeah.
Well, I wonder how many kids Go ahead.
protect your kids from college by not saving money for college. It's a waste. Yeah.
If you're going to save some money up for your kids that was going to give them a ride to college, why not just let them, invest it in a business or buy a house or something like that? You'd be way better off with some real estate.
If you, So if you're going to send, if your kids go into college,
the whole idea is to not send them to
incentivize them. To get real degrees. Colleges in America provide real degrees, and part of the problem is that people out there are like, when a kid comes into college, it's like, so what do you want to do? Nobody says, would you like to make money and be valued?
Mm-hmm.
Or would you like to be a bartender that knows a lot about art history?
Mm-hmm. The harp.
So, you know, the STEM careers are out there. Any, you know, smart kids can be engineers and they can be lawyers and doctors and these sorts of things. And those need to have a degree. But, you know, lots of people getting lots of degrees that they don't need, including that communications degree that you got, Ian.
I don't have a communications
what
degree,
was yours
dude.
In?
I didn't go to college for a degree. I went to 2 years of associates.
AA is a degree.
It's basically a waste of time.
All right.
Yeah.
That's fair.
Yeah. And it would have been a waste of time if it had been 4 years. Dave.
We have a co-host who has an MBA.
So
I mean, some degrees are worth something. A lot of degrees are worth nothing. And that's the problem. They've become degree mills, these colleges. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Dave, anything else? Go ahead.
It does seem like there is one other restriction, which is sort of restricting students' political activity off campus.
Hmm.
It says, quote, avoid social gatherings on and off campus. And, well, it says
right,
social
that's the party,
gatherings.
But
so
that's
maybe
the
that
party
be.
Ban.
Yeah. Okay. So yeah, for involving more than 10 people. So that wouldn't be political that it necessarily.
Oh, so I guess all they have to do is call every social gathering a protest.
So who are you voting for?
No, but you see what I'm saying? Like there were, when the Black Lives Matter thing were happening big time, like around here a few months ago, there was this sort of excuse of, oh, well, it's okay to go out and violate all the social distancing rules because it's a protest and this is really important. So, you know, as long as you're willing to risk it, okay, come on out, but make sure you wear a mask because all the Black Lives Matter events were always encouraging people to wear masks. But the talk around these events was that, like, well, it's okay if you're protesting. So it sounds to me like that might be the excuse. All they have to do if they're going to throw a college party this semester is just call it a protest. You know, put some signs out or something like that, and now it's not a party. It's just a protest. It's not social. We're here to try to change things.
We're changing the world.
Yeah. One drink at a time.
Over a beer, yep.
Yeah. Which is, of course, how it was done, right? Back in the day, there were the American revolutionaries were meeting in bars.
That's
over
right.
Beers.
Yep.
Right. So anyway, thank you, Dave, for your call tonight. I definitely appreciate hearing from you. And I think the college is starting next week. Isn't that right, Tom?
Yeah, it starts on Monday, first day of class.
Obviously, that's different for other colleges and other places, but that probably means that tonight's going to be the first party night back, would be my guess, because I think they probably normally they move in the week before, like on a Wednesday, right?
Yeah.
The bars are just waiting.
Wondering what it's going to look like downtown tonight.
Uh-huh, and I'm wondering what kind of level of enforcement we're going to see on this no party rule, because technically, I don't think Keene police can enforce the college rules, can they? I don't think they can.
I don't believe they can.
Yeah, I think what Keene police can do is if the college does what they did to Dave and they've done to me in the past and they don't want you there, so they trespass you off the campus, get off the campus or else we're calling the police, then the police can remove you if you don't leave, right? Because then it's a trespass. But besides that, if you're just violating the college's rules and they tell you to leave, besides having to leave when they tell you to, I don't think they can really do much else if you're a non-student. If you are a student, then it would seem that the college campus safety would have to conduct the investigation on any suspected parties, because they'd have to be able to identify who was at the parties in order to bring them up on these kangaroo courts that Ridley was talking about.
I've got a friend going to college in New York, and they're putting up QR codes mm-hmm. outside of all the classroom doors, and you have to check in with your phone in order to go to class, and it's like a form of contact tracing.
But there's no auditing of classes anymore, right?
Yeah, I guess not.
But there's no app that they're required to install?
I think it does involve an app. I need to ask him and get more details.
Because we were reading a story earlier this week about, I think it was Albion College in Michigan mm-hmm. that is requiring all of its students to have its app, which will trace their location at all times.
Yeah.
And
I, for one, am much more comforted.
And if you go outside of the college's what they call the COVID bubble,
mm-hmm.
which is a 4.5-mile perimeter around the campus, apparently, that
why'd they decide that size?
I don't know.
Arbitrary decision making. Yeah.
Yeah, you're not allowed to leave the college campus area.
COVID bubble,
or else you could face one of these show trials that they have, or I guess not even a show trial. They won't even let the media in. Toll free number is 855-450-FREE. If you want to join us here, let's talk a little bit about this DNC, this convention. There's a hilarious story we got to share coming up.
Remember when you first heard about Bitcoin? How long did it take you to realize this little project would soon change the world? Do you kind of wish you had gotten involved sooner? Well, now is your chance to be a part of the next revolution in money. Intercoin is working to finally make crypto go mainstream. It's designed to be scalable enough to support everyday payments and even elections without the state. Bitcoin was originally supposed to be a peer-to-peer cash system, the way we would all pay one another without having to trust any third party. But instead, over time, it mostly became a store of value. That's because every 10 minutes, the Bitcoin network must put all transactions into a block, and that block can only hold so much. If crypto is to become mainstream, for people to use it for everyday payments, we need a new architecture. One that is as secure as Bitcoin while being far more scalable. Check out intercoin.org to find out more and maybe pick up some of those coins for yourself.
Are you a cryptocurrency advocate? The Crypto Tip is the ideal outreach tool to help new people discover cryptocurrency. It's a printable business card size tip that you can give to service providers, preferably in addition to a good cash tip. When the server scans the QR code, it'll bring up an explanation of cryptocurrency, how to install a wallet, and allow them to claim the tip. If they don't claim the crypto, you get your tip refunded to you after a time period you specify. Plus, if they do claim the tip, you get an email alert. Create as many tips as you want at cryptotip.org. That's cryptotip.org. What if you want to hear the latest episode of Free Talk Live, but all you have is your phone, you forgot to download our archive, and you have no data connection? You can call our listen line at 641-793-0191. That's a long-distance number, so you may incur charges. If not, listen as long as you want. 641-793-0191. The Free Talk Live listen line, 641-793-0191.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Fox News, just a couple hours away from night four of the Democratic National Convention, with the former vice president ready to accept the presidential nomination.
One night after former President Barack Obama launched a blistering attack on Donald Trump, Joe Biden will step into the spotlight to make his case to the American people here on the final night of the DNC.
Donald Trump hasn't grown into the job because he can't. And the consequences of that failure are severe.
Biden preparing to deliver the biggest speech of his decades-long political career. Embracing the final night's theme, America's Promise, he will lay out his steps to build back better and reinforce his campaign's central message. Formally accepts his party's nomination for president.
Fox's Caroline Shively. Last night's convention drew the biggest ratings so far, with Nielsen reporting 22.8 million people watched across all broadcast and cable networks. President Trump took his campaign right to Biden's childhood doorstep today, campaigning near Scranton, Pennsylvania.
You want a vision of your life under Biden presidency? Think of the smoldering ruins in Minneapolis, the violent anarchy of Portland, the bloodstained sidewalks of Chicago.
The president promised the crowd that in a second term, he will create 10 million jobs, hire more police, and ban sanctuary cities. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo has formally notified the UN Security Council the U.S. will reimpose sanctions against Iran for violating the 2015 nuclear deal.
President Trump and this administration have discarded the fiction that the regime merely seeks a peaceful nuclear program. We will never allow the Islamic Republic of Iran to have a nuclear weapon.
UK, France, and Germany said they can't support the move because it's not compatible with efforts to support the nuclear deal. America is listening to Fox News.
. 2020 hasn't let up, but we have to keep this economy rolling. NetSuite will help your business make that happen. That's why over 21,000 companies, including Boll & Branch, makers of the world's softest sheets, choose NetSuite by Oracle, the world's number one cloud business system. NetSuite gives you visibility and control over your financials, HR, inventory, e-commerce, and more. Everything you need, all in one place. We talked to David Reed, CFO of Boll & Branch, about how they use NetSuite.
Before NetSuite, we were stitched together with spreadsheets and hope. Now I have only one source of truth for our financials, HR, inventory, and supply chain. Because NetSuite is cloud-based, working from home didn't change a thing. We're still bringing affordable luxury into homes all across America. I'm now closing the books 5 to 10 times faster thanks to NetSuite.
NetSuite surveyed hundreds of business leaders and assembled a playbook of the top strategies they're using as America reopens for business. Receive your free guide, 7 actions businesses need to take now, and schedule your free product tour at NetSuite.com.
netsuite.com/fox.
Florida once again reporting lower numbers of COVID-19 infections.
Florida's Department of Health reports a little more than 4,500 new coronavirus positives as of this morning, but also finds the percent positive rate for Wednesday to be 6.75%, which is the lowest the state has seen in months. While the state has now seen more than 10,000 die from COVID-19, the number of people hospitalized continues to dwindle, with about 5,000 cases remaining. In Broward County, Florida, Evan Brown, Fox News.
New York will allow voters to request absentee ballots for the general election due to the pandemic. Under a new state law signed today by Governor Andrew Cuomo, lawmakers passed the bill last month. The governor allowed voters in the June primary to vote by absentee ballots due to fears of spreading the virus at polling sites. A social media company under threat of a U.S. ban fights back.
TikTok is pushing back against claims that it poses a threat to U.S. national security, unveiling TikTok U.S. accusations it spies on Americans. The video app also rolling out a Twitter page for this called TikTok_com. Support nor information on our platform. To a Beijing-based company called ByteDance facing heat for its data collection policies. President Trump signing an executive order blocking all U.S. transactions with the app's parent company. Kristen Goodwin, Fox News.
The Oklahoma Zoo, featured in Netflix Tiger King documentary, has closed after a federal investigation of maltreatment of animals and the suspension of its license. The Greater Wynwood Exotic Animal Park closed to the public after the Department of Agriculture suspended the exhibition license for owner Jeff Lowe for 21 days. This is Fox News.
Following reports of a newly posted job listing at area marketing firm Swenson Digital, The Onion spoke to a few of the 1,400 applicants who claim they are, quote, absolutely perfect for this position.
When I first saw this opening, I knew it was right for me. I've got tons of experience. I've got all the skills they're looking for.
If you look at my resume, I've got everything they're looking for. I mean, I've held similar jobs like this in the past. I'm extremely driven. I really think this is going to work out.
I've got a BA in marketing, which the posting said was recommended, so I think that'll bode really well for me. I've had plenty of team experience, and I think that would stand out, not to mention the fact that I'm great with
web design and HTML, and pretty proficient with Excel and PowerPoint. Also, I think the culture is
very me, you know? I think I'd fit in well with the other employees. I also think I had a great resume
and cover letter. I think as soon as they interview me, they'll see I'm the perfect candidate.
As of this video's release, Swenson Digital had extended a job offer to an applicant who happens to be a friend of the boss's son.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
It's Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything that you want here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE like freedom. That's 855-450-3733. We have the Discord call-in line rooms over at discord.lrn.fm. In the studio with you tonight, you've got Ian.
Tyler.
And Mark.
So we're going to get into more of your calls and thoughts. We got a person calling in on our Discord lines, which, of course, that's the best way to get on the air with us. You'll sound awesome if you've got even a semi-decent microphone. It's just an instant upgrade to call quality. And then we're going to get into this Democratic National Convention, which, given the whole ridiculous response to COVID-19, the overreaction, the fear, they have gone to a virtual convention format. Now, this isn't the first time this has happened. Actually, the first time this happened was the Libertarian Party's convention that happened, I believe, at the end of May. So that was actually the first time in history that a political party held an online-only convention. And now the Democrats are trying to do the same thing, except they are trying to make theirs, I guess, to some extent, entertaining. I've got a pretty entertaining clip to play here, and absolutely hilarious news story as well. We'll share that with you in just a moment. But first, let's go to Ala Loca. She's on our Discord lines. Go ahead, Ala Loca, calling on the amp line.
Yes, actually. Cool. So I just wanted to talk about the census. Do you guys have any cool stories of
as of late? Anything happened to you?
No, I missed them. They came by because I don't fill out the census, and that means they're going to send somebody by to try to get answers out of this household. They did send somebody by, but I generally am not awake in the mornings, so I wasn't able to answer the door, and apparently my roommate also was not able to answer the door. They left a notice of visit, which is a piece of paper that they leave on your building to inform you that they were there. And so presumably they will be trying to come back at some point.
So I'm a legal resident of Saipan, the Commonwealth of Northern Mariana Islands, or, you know, U.S. Marianas.
Do they do the census in Saipan?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
They do a census there. But I'm not there. Mm-hmm. But I am. So what I mean when I say that is the Internal Revenue Service, according to their code, I am currently in the CNMI because I left within 14 days of a declared emergency. Mm-hmm. And so I'm there for the entire length of the emergency.
Which is still going on.
Which is still going on. So I could be on the island for hundreds of days, and I have no idea. I can't get counted over there.
Because you're not physically there.
As the census. I have no idea how they go about counting people in the CNMI.
Well, the reason you say that is because there are no addresses, right?
Right. There are no addresses. And so,
but they may know how many houses are on a given road.
Yeah, they could very well go house to house and just knock, knock, knock. But just because you knock on a door doesn't mean somebody has answered to tell you how many people live in a given location.
Right.
They could guess bedrooms. They know that information. But that's about it. So if someone were to come by the house that I am staying at in New Hampshire, there's nobody who's staying at the house that has a bunch of people at it that actually would call that house their residence. So this kind of going around in the summer thing is a little confusing. There's a lot of people who are at cabins and lake houses and, you know, sailing and doing a lot of things over the summer with their kids that aren't at home. And I just don't even – I wouldn't even know. I wouldn't even know where to start with if somebody came to the house.
So why do you ask, Alaloka? What about you? Have you had some experience?
Well, yeah, I've actually been hounded down twice.
Really?
Yeah, which is funny because the first – I don't know, adult years of my life, I've never gotten a letter or anything like that. But since I've bought my own house, I've had two visits so far. The first one was a little startling. The guy came at literally at 9 o'clock at night. And
wow.
I was like, he's like, what's going on? I'm like, don't open the door to strangers.
Looking like you're going to get shot.
Yeah, well, that's what I said. I was like, don't open the door to strangers. It's freaking 9 o'clock. What are you doing? He's like, it's somebody with a badge. I'm like, even more reason. Don't open the door.
He had a badge?
He has some identifier thing, you know, like a. Well, I couldn't really read it through the door.
Was it a name tag or was it a badge?
No, it was a tag, name tag.
Okay.
But regardless, he opened the door and he was like, "Can I help you?" And my husband was like, "No," or whatever. And basically, he's like, "Well, is there an adult here?" And my husband's like, "No." He's like, is there anyone over 21? No.
Wait a minute. How old does your husband look?
We really, really look young. At least myself, I can say I look 20 or 18 easily.
Gotcha.
Yeah, he looks pretty young. But he left. The thing that really pissed me off is that he parked in my driveway.
Yeah.
That annoyed me the most. Like, how do you have the nerve to just park right all the way up into the driveway? But besides that, then I had another lady who came on the weekend around 12 o'clock in the afternoon, and we just didn't open the door. So it was just, and that was like 3 days after. So I'm like, damn, they're pretty persistent coming over.
Yeah, that's interesting. They in 2010, they came by one time, and I was here, and I recorded video of it. That's on the Free Keen YouTube channel. If you search for census, you can find them both. And then they sent somebody, I don't know how many weeks later the other one was, but you can probably look at the date stamps on the videos, see how relatively close they were. And I refused to answer their questions on both occasions. So what about you, Tyler? Anything happening over at your house?
No, nobody's come by. And
did you guys fill it out?
No. Well, it's not. First off, it's not my house, and I don't respond to mail that's not direct. Are directed directly to me. So, yeah. I mean, like, I don't know if somebody did fill it out for the house, but I certainly didn't.
Gotcha.
And nobody came by.
Well, I will say that I'm paranoid to leave my house now because it was just so frequently that they came after one another at random times of the day. And I just don't want to encounter them. I don't want to have a discussion with them. I don't want anything to do with them.
Yeah.
So,
well, you're not. I mean, from what I can tell, you have no obligation to speak to these people. Now, they are going to try to threaten you. via their paperwork, right? Because the paperwork will, the individuals probably won't threaten you directly because they're just trying to make, you know, they just have a temporary job, and you know, once the census is over, they're out of work. So they're not like professional government bureaucrats or anything like that, like career bureaucrats. Most of these people, these are just people that need a job, basically. So like
they look like they were taking pictures and stuff, because the last guy who came here at nine. We didn't leave my driveway for at least a good 10 minutes, and I was looking for
Okay, well, maybe they're enforced. Maybe they're going to crack down this year. I don't know. Maybe people are going to go to prison finally for this. But in 2010, they didn't do anything to us except send visitors twice and then gave up. And that was it.
Well, we'll see. But yep. I'll just let you know if I don't ever call back, then you know why.
Okay. Yeah, definitely let us know. Thank you, Alaloka, for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you.
Take care.
Well, you got to love that. You answer the door at your own home. I know they've got kids, right? Like, she's married with kids, and then they ask you, are your parents home?
I'm trying to get what the bad thing about parking in somebody's driveway is. I mean, what's the driveway for?
I don't know. I think she was just generally offended.
Might be a little too familiar. I mean, park on the curb, you know.
Okay. Well, I mean, what if it's one of those streets you can't park in the curb on? I don't know.
Good point. I don't know. Yeah. I just think that if somebody came to my house, some official came to my house at 9 at night, I'm up late usually. Mm-hmm. I don't have kids or nothing. But, like, that's a good excuse to give them an earful. Yeah. It's like, it's 9 o'clock at night. Get the, you know, off my property. Good Lord.
Yeah, that's a little crazy.
Yeah.
I mean, the only person who should be coming here at 9 o'clock at night is the delivery man. Like UPS, sometimes sometimes they'll come at like 8 p.m. I've seen it happen. But, you know, past dark, or the FedEx guy, he's got so many boxes on the truck, and his day is not over until they're gone. So he's sometimes those guys
need to hire more of those guys.
Totally reasonable. Yeah, plus you want your package. You know, I don't want this guy at my door 9 at night.
And they don't want to talk to you. They just want to let you know the package is there and then leave, right?
Right. That's
it. I have an opposing story. The sheriff in town quit his job and decided to run for Senate, the state Senate seat. Mm-hmm. And he was out campaigning for that. And he walked up my driveway, which at the time was 440 feet.
But there's no trespassing signs at the front of
there
the driveway.
There is none.
Right.
But the idea that he parked down at the road seems so strange to me. Why wouldn't you drive up the driveway? I mean, he didn't even know how long it was.
Maybe he wanted the exercise.
Well, he certainly got it.
Yeah.
But then I'm working out splitting wood, and here comes Johnny Law, whom I recognize because I knew who Dick Foot was.
That's his name.
And I said, my wife happened to be out too. She was in the garden. I said, "Dear God, Laura, it's the law." So there you go.
He makes an appearance in Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. If you want to check that movie out at victimlesscrimespree.com. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Well, how many people were participating in the Democratic National Committee? Apparently not enough to fill an entire screen of Zoom windows. We'll explain what that means coming up here in a moment. 855-450-FREE like freedom. This is Free Talk Live.
Maxwell, she was scratching and losing some hair. My vet, she says, oh, he must be allergic to chicken. Another vet said, he's the drain. Third vet said, it's the weather. Then somebody said,
DINOVITE.com.
It took 2 weeks, and the dog stopped itching. The hair stopped falling out. The Dynavite is a big part of Maxwell's diet.
You get some Dynavite, how happy your dog will be.
DINOVITE.com.
Did you know you can support freedom of speech just by visiting shop.freetalklive.com? You'll see links to Walmart, Love Java, Newegg, and more. Every day, Free Talk Live is at the forefront of the liberty movement as the biggest liberty-oriented talk show in the world, giving you a platform to be heard on any topic. Get listener-only specials without doing anything other than an extra click. Visit shop.freetalklive.com. Use the links and buy what you'd be buying anyway. Take action now. Save and support freedom. Visit shop.freetalklive.com. It's shop.freetalklive.com.
Got shaving irritation? Shave Secret Shaving Oil can help stop it. Shave Secret doesn't cost much and is an all-American product. My name is Chuck Howard, and I developed Shave Secret and pioneered its use starting back in 1991. Ingrown hairs drove me nuts for years. Shaving oil changed all that. Why put up with ingrown hair bumps, red rash, nicks, and cuts? Shave Secret provides men and women with what we believe is the best shave ever. Our proprietary blend of 100% natural base and essential oils plus a hint of menthol was designed to help eliminate shaving irritations like ingrown hairs, bumps, red rash, nicks, and cuts. We'll lose those shaving irritations. Available at Super Walmart, HEB, Wegmans, Giant Eagle, Discount Drug, Navy and Marine Exchanges, Amazon, and ShaveSecret.com. Use the code FTL for Free Talk Live and get a discount. Shave Secret, the best shave ever.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this, right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it, and once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world, so I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, connect with others via the forum at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. Some of you asked, and now we've delivered. LRN.FM's live Keene, New Hampshire studio shows are now streamed in HD on Twitch. Visit our channel at twitch.lrn.fm and give it a follow. If you have Amazon Prime, you get one free subscription on Twitch. If you use it on our channel, Twitch will give LRN.FM a monthly piece of your Prime subscription cost. So please watch, follow, share, and subscribe to twitch.lrn.fm. That's twitch.lrn.fm.
Do you want more businesses accepting Bitcoin Cash and Dash? Now, with AnyPay, you earn passive income for every purchase at those businesses. Finally, a financial incentive to spread Bitcoin Cash and Dash. You made it happen, so you receive the rewards. Download the AnyPay Cash Register app and add your cryptocurrency wallet addresses. Then, install it at a real-life business and tell us what you did at AnyPayInc.com. AnyPayInc.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.FM.
It is Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us right here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, like freedom. That's 855-450-3733. We have the Discord call-in line rooms at discord.lrn.fm. Hop into one of those. You'll sound like you're sitting here with us. Tonight, it's Ian,
Tyler,
and Mark.
All right, so Intercoin, want to let you know what they are up to. They got some cool stuff going on. Every member of a community can receive a periodic airdrop of money that they can use on necessities thanks to Intercoin. This UBI can be funded by outside donors or by the community by democratically voting to gradually inflate their internal money supply. Community currencies powered by Intercoin enable communities to help their own without waiting for the federal government and without disincentivizing paid work. The arrangement is completely voluntary and democratic. Intercoin is attempting to regain some of our freedoms that are threatened on the internet and in meat space. We think it's important here on Free Talk Live, so we accepted $40,000 worth of Intercoin tokens from Intercoin Incorporated for advertising. If you think freedom is important too, check out Intercoin at intercoin.org. You can invest in this project and potentially make big gains, or just be involved and perhaps shape its future. Intercoin.org. As we continue, we're going back to your phone calls and thoughts, and then we'll just touch briefly on a pretty funny story from the Democratic National Convention, just making them look really sad. But first, we go to Steve in Fort Smith, Arkansas. Steve, you're on Free Talk Live. Listen to KFPW.
What's up, guys?
Hey.
How you doing?
What's on your mind?
Well, you know, I think in Arkansas, if I think the teachers may send someone to a kid's house if they didn't see a firearm of some kind. I mean, that's just the dumbest crap I've ever heard.
You're referring to the Baltimore story, case listeners are just tuning in, where a 11-year-old was targeted by the police who came and searched his room with his mother's permission.
The Navy vet.
She ended up feeling sorry that she made that decision because he had a gun hanging on the wall behind him during his class, and they were doing the remote learning thing.
The BB gun.
The teacher snitched him out, yeah.
Yeah, you know, when I was like 8 or 9 years old, my grandpa had, of course, I grew up on a 500-acre cattle farm, mm-hmm. and, you know, there was only about, I don't know, a tenth of that was pasture. The rest was where we shot the hell out of turkey and deer.
Nice.
Year round. If we wanted meat, we went and killed something. So, you know, that's, you know, that was my grandfather's American dream. He wanted property. He grew up on the south side of Chicago, and he was like, he was a Navy vet, 21 years, and he was so sick of the water and people that he said, I'm putting an oar on my shoulder and I'm walking inland. And when somebody asks me what that is, I'm buying property.
Yeah.
But,
nice, huh?
But yeah, he, in 1963, they bought land in Northeast Arkansas. They moved from Connecticut. And you know, we grew up hunting, fishing, you know, I never really hunt for sport now because I did it so much as a kid. It's not even fun really. Like, you know, we didn't do the whole tracking them and, you know, all these guys, we just, we'd go out there and just sit on a limb until we saw something we wanted to shoot. And, you know, that's how you did it.
So, yeah, what you're describing is a completely different culture than what goes on in inner cities like Baltimore, right? Where you're surrounded by leftists. You're surrounded by people who've never seen a gun except in a Hollywood movie. And they've been trained their whole lives going to government school that guns are bad and guns are dangerous and guns are evil. And anyone who touches them must be a bad person or whatever the propaganda is. And so it's just a totally different mindset. Whereas when you're, you know, you're out from the rural areas, country areas, you grew up with guns. I mean, even the Democrats grew up around guns here in New Hampshire, which is one of the reasons why New Hampshire is one of the best states as far as gun rights is concerned, because a lot of the lefties have some experience with them, mm-hmm. you know?
Right. Well, you know, my grandparents voted Democrat. I mean, I think I've told you guys before, they were friends with the Clintons. Mm-hmm. I was at the governor's mansion a couple times before I was 8 years old. I mean, I thought the Clintons were weird then, and I think they're even weirder now, but, you know, that's neither here nor there. I can see how it's going to be different in the larger urban areas. I mean, even places like Little Rock and Fort Smith here, you know, it's going to be a little different in areas like that, but, you know, still at the end of the day, it's a freaking BB gun. It's mounted on the kid's wall, and some uppity parent, apparently, am I correct?
That's correct.
At least one
about it.
Yeah,
and so it's probably just some housewife who doesn't have anything better to do, or one of these bums that are sitting on unemployment still because they're making more than they would if they would go back to work, just griping and moaning about something that really has no bearing on them.
And, yeah, well, people are getting into other people's business, you know, and that's nothing new. Yeah. The state has been around to encourage snitching for a long time. In fact, I've seen billboards in like New York City that encourage people to call the police, call a certain snitch line if you know where a gun is. So, like, it's propagandized out there in some of these big cities that you know where a gun is, you call, you'll get a cash reward if we get a conviction.
Yeah, man, I'm really glad
you guys were saying you all had Daisy BB guns.
I had a Red Ryder when I was a kid. Yeah,
I had a Crossman.
I think mine was probably a Crossman. I don't remember what it was.
Okay. Well, I was going to give you a little piece of trivia real quick before I get out of here. Daisy BB guns are manufactured right here in Rogers, Arkansas, about 45 minutes from where I am. And until the 60s, they made 22 rifles also. And I actually own a Daisy 22 rifle that is pretty rare. But anyway, I just thought you'd find out. We were talking about BB guns.
Yeah, that's cool. I didn't know Daisy did that. I'm going to have to look that up after this.
Steve, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. In fact, Mark, he talked about people in the cities and leaving the cities, and that's what his parents did ultimately. And you've got a story about an exodus from the city. So pull that up when we get the chance. We'll get to it here.
Yeah, before we go on, I just want to say I really like that Steve brought this up again because that's an important point that I think that people on the left and these suburbanites don't get. The way he described it, I had a similar childhood. You know, I grew up on a farm and like hunting varmints was just part of daily life in the summer and stuff. And, you know, it's a culture. And these people that want to talk about like respecting people's cultures, they want to completely deny that this is part of American
culture.
Yeah, it's a really important part of their culture.
It's a great point.
Yeah. Well, and it's like, it's funny because, you know, The Mandalorian came out last year and one of the things from it is, you know, weapons are part of my religion. And so many people just jumped on that wagon. They're like, yeah, weapons are part of my religion. And I love that attitude.
So DNC, the Democratic National Committee, I've never actually, or convention put on by the Democratic National Committee. I've never actually watched one of these things. I've seen enough of.
I've watched a few. Yeah.
My God, how can you stand it?
Well, you just do other things while it's on.
Make it into a drinking game.
God, it's so long. I mean, you'd end up in the hospital.
Well, you can clean afterwards. The house. There's plenty of time, plenty of house to clean.
So, anyway, I don't watch these things, and I have not been watching this one, but I heard enough about it already to where people are saying it is embarrassingly bad.
Yes, I have heard that.
Mm-hmm. So you've not watched it then?
I have not watched this year's at all.
So not only is the production quality really bad, and in fact, production quality generally has gone into the toilet since COVID. Now all these shows that they have, I guess, are being made from the host's living room or something, right? Like you got mm-hmm. Ellen DeGeneres and Stephen Colbert, and these guys are just in their den, you know, doing their professional Hollywood show. And we can talk more about it. Coming up here, you can share your thoughts as well. Free Talk Live.
News from news.bitcoin.com. Chinese banks limit customers' ability to buy gold. Chinese flooding and potential dam collapse threatens many Bitcoin operations. Withdrawals from crypto exchanges increase, indicating perhaps more people are holding their coin for themselves. Tentative agreement met to stabilize Bitcoin Cash mining in conjunction with the currency's third birthday. Bitcoin.com is your source for getting started with cryptocurrencies, getting a wallet, buying Bitcoin Cash, mining, and all the latest cryptocurrency news at news.bitcoin.com. Divi's been a pretty good investment for Free Talk Live. Their ad campaign started in September 2019, and from mid-March to mid-July, the values soared by 10 times. It's not too late. Divi's new wallet hasn't even released yet, and other things are happening that I can't even say on the radio. If you want to invest and potentially do well, go to DiviProject.org. I can tell you that FTL is deepening its partnership with the guys from DiviProject.org. Past performance is not an indication of future profit. DiviProject.org. DiviProject.org.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
When you're coping with bad news and the news media come calling, and they will, don't clam up. As notorious political figures find out the hard way, the cover-up can be worse than the crime. So get out in front of unfavorable news about your company, your group, or organization, or yourself. The sooner you confront a negative story, the sooner it will be over. Responding as quickly to negative stories as you do to positive ones enhances your credibility vulnerability. Hiding embarrassing information or lying will do more damage than damage control. Never stonewall. Tell your side of the story, use specifics, and detail what corrective action has already been taken. Respond in kind. If the issue is emotional, don't sound like a cold, unemotional Mr. Spock. For more tips on critical communication skills for the way things are now, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Yep, it's Free Talk Live. You can bring up whatever you want. Toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE, like freedom. That's 855-450-3733. We have the Discord call-in line rooms at discord.lrn.fm. In the studio tonight, it's Ian,
Tyler,
and Mark.
We're going to go back into your calls and thoughts. But first, just a ridiculous story about the Democratic National Convention going on. I guess, is today the last day, or was that yesterday? I don't know. I don't pay any attention to it, but I know it's actually been going on, and RT has got a story from RT.com. When Kamala Harris was receiving applause at
Kamala is how they want you to pronounce it. Kamala.
Okay.
Like a Kamala.
Kamala Harris was receiving applause at the end of her DNC speech, it became apparent that some of the virtual clappers seem just to have been duplicated images of the same audience members.
Oh, no.
And what that means is there's a grid, okay? So on these video conferencing systems, which not all of our listeners may be familiar with, right now the video conference thing is hot. It's everywhere. Every business is using it. It's Zoom this, Zoom that. Zoom is this one company that offers it. Of course, there's others. I think Discord's got it now. I think Telegram's got it now. I mean, Facebook has it now. Microsoft has it now. So there's a ton of these platforms. Everybody wants to be on these platforms and having their meetings so they don't have to go into the office. And that's where they're having the Democratic National Convention.
Right.
There does appear to be somebody in a room with a stage. So I'm seeing a screenshot here from the convention. So it does appear they have some sort of a facility, but there's no one there. Everyone is online watching this.
So there are a few people there doing sort of video
work. Production work. Yeah, production work. Needs to be done. And the production quality is not very good. We can get into that.
Thank
up
you
here
for your service.
In a moment. But what they have is they've got a sort of a computer window with what appears to be six windows, sub-windows, so like little boxes in one big window, little screens with people on them. So six across and then looks like five down. So there's 30 positions here that are filled with faces, smiling faces, happy faces, people who are happy to see Kamala Harris give her DNC speech and, you know, applauding at the very end. Yay, because this is their audience, okay? This is now presumably there's more than this watching online, I think. But these are their audience members that have cameras and they're in the call, right? So they're
these are
there.
The super delegates.
They're there to be, I don't know if that's what they are, but they're there to be used as the audience for the purpose of this production.
Okay. Right?
So at the end of the speech, yay, Kamala! Well, on the screen of 30 people, there were at least three of the 30 that were duplicates. And you can see in the photograph that, they've got little circles around them to show you which of the two are the same. Here's the other two that are the same, and here's the
it's
third
like one of those
two
games that you get at a bar, you know, where you find
match
the
games
duplicates.
Yeah, match games. So the vice presidential nominee's address to the Democratic National Convention was supposed to be the grand finale of Wednesday's event as she accepted the much-hyped vice presidential nomination. Because the gathering was virtual due to COVID-19 safety measures, Harris was provided with an online video audience to applaud and underscore the speech's importance. Having delivered it, the senator turned around to clap along with her 30 supposed listeners whose images were projected onto the giant grid. However, three of the clappers were simply duplicates of other applauding viewers. Comedically minded netizens could not let go of the incident and found much mirth riffing on the idea the Democratic Party was unable to, quote, find enough people that actually like Kamala. So that's the idea, is that they couldn't find 30 cameras with people on them to fill this screen.
I believe that.
Yeah, so
she dropped out first, didn't she?
Meaning she was one of the first dropouts?
I believe she was like supposedly dropout.
Yeah, she did not perform well, yeah. I can say that much. So I recently took the Tony Robbins course. Have you heard of this guy, Ian?
Yeah, he's a self-help guy.
I suppose he wouldn't like that terminology, but let's call him a life coach kind of fella. Whatever. Whatever the thing is that he does. He's sort of an inspirational speaker kind of guy. And he had, because he had planned, of course, to do his big, huge events that they do in stadiums that include like the fire walk and the like punch through the board and all these things. He instead has to set it up so that you're doing it at your home. And he has these...
All right, get out your coals.
Well, actually, in this case, they did have you buy the wood for the punch-through thing.
Okay.
And the people who did not buy the proper wood, some of those had some difficult time. If you could imagine trying to punch through a 2x4, you're just not going
to
do that.
There's a whole trick to that. You got to get the right grain, all that stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, we got the board. It was half-inch pine. So normally, like, you know, if you put up a tongue and groove along your wall, it'd be 1 inch. Yeah, you can punch, a grown man can punch through that, but you got to have something that people can, you know, ladies and the kids can punch through. So half-inch pine is basically tailor-made to be punched through. But nonetheless, I watched this. 60,000 people was the upward number that they talked about taking this event online at home at the time. And you saw this wall of videos behind him. And this is what they're trying to replicate here.
Right.
But they've got 30 people.
And not even.
Pardon
27.
Me. I misstated. 27 people. Yeah. And they had to reduplicate three of them.
People need to face the Democrats are just going to lose this one. If you hate Trump, yo, I get it. I don't like the guy either. But he's in it for four more years because as much as you don't want to admit it, there are a lot of people out there excited to go punch that Trump ticket. You know what I mean? But nobody cares about Kamala Harris and nobody likes Joe Biden. It was just a horrible ticket. I think the reason this is happening.
How did he end up getting the nomination if no one likes him?
Well, there's
a great
conspiracy
question,
theory.
Honestly.
Right? That Barack Obama picked up the phone and said when Bernie Sanders was ripping it up early on in the primary, and he picks it up and goes, I've got to talk to you guys. Looks like Joe's going to lose here, and we can't have that. So basically, offers were made. All of you are going to be involved in some way, shape, or form, but we need you on board. We think Joe's the best guy to take on Donald Trump, and we cannot let Bernie Sanders have the nomination.
Didn't you say before the show that AOC, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, actually nominated Bernie Sanders from the convention floor?
Yeah, 90 seconds she got before they ripped her off,
I guess.
They
cut her mic?
I don't know that they cut her mic.
Oh, wow.
I'm just saying, all she got was 90 seconds.
Yeah, that's probably all she had to do the intro. So that's interesting. There you go. That's basically the news. I do have a brief clip from the convention that is just so hilarious, and I wanted to play it for you guys. But first, Ryan is on the line in Houston, Texas. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Ryan.
Hey, guys. Caught the end of the show last night when y'all were talking about the scammers and whatnot. And your buddy, they got on his computer and his bank and I did all this stuff. So what it is, if you have any web page open, you can right click on it. There'll be something that says inspect element. Now I could find a value on that says your balance and change that value to anything that I want and then click out of it. And now, unless you refresh the page, your balance for all intents and purposes has changed. And anybody can do that. You don't need any special computer training. The whole genre of videos to watch on that is called scam baiting. And just YouTube that, and it's hilarious.
Now, is that where people are receiving a scam call and they just play along with them and just to kind of screw with them?
No, they call the numbers. They seek them out. I mean, it's what they do for a living. And they're just one step ahead, but he's using a voice changer like an old lady. And they're not only funny and clever, but they delete their files, they get their personal pictures, and if they have a...
Wait a minute. Well, hold on. Just to clarify, you're saying the person calling the scammers, the person who is trying to scam bait them, is able to get the information from the scammers?
Look, when they open those AnyDesk connections, that goes both ways. That's not a one-way connection.
So they go onto the scammers' computers, delete everything.
No.
Get copies of all their victims, warn them.
No way.
And now when they have mules, yeah, now the mules in the United States, if they ever are stupid enough to mail money, they're going and showing up at those P.O. boxes. I mean, just YouTube scam baiting. My two favorites are Scammer Revolt and Kit Boga.
Thank you for the recommendations, Ryan. I appreciate hearing from you tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. You can share your thoughts, whether on the DNC, scam baiters, or whatever you want. Free Talk Live.
When you have a pain in the neck, a real pain in the neck, back, shoulder, or legs, you now have two convenient choices to get fast relief without taking another pill. Because now, Sunny Bay heating wraps and pillows are available at both Amazon and Walmart. Yes, see Sunny Bay's 4.5 to 5-star customer reviews on Amazon.com or Walmart.com. Our made in the USA, microwavable heat wraps, heatable neck pillows, and extra large body wraps are designed better for perfect support where and when you need it. Even while driving, Sunny Bay wraps will not burn and stay balanced to provide soothing hot or cold therapy to help treat temporary or chronic pain. And the best part? Sunny Bay quality products start at under $20. Join thousands of happy customers and see why Sunny Bay products have a lifetime 100% positive rating on both Amazon and Etsy. It's easy. Click Amazon or Walmart and search today for Sunny Bay.
Today, many of us are paying attention to our health, and what we eat plays an important role. But so often, the water we drink is a mere afterthought when it should be a primary part of our daily nutrition. Real Water would like to change how you think about the water you drink and how it can play an important role in helping your body restore balance and reach its full potential. The key benefits of every bottle of Real Water are stabilized negative ions, balanced pH, detoxification, and it hydrates you like never before. And yes, it tastes great. Real Water is beyond alkalinity, and due to its proprietary process called E2 technology, it's the only drinking water on the market that can maintain a stable negative ionization, which means real science in every bottle. Order your Real Water today and take advantage of special pricing for this audience only by calling 1-855-REALWTR or visiting buyrealwaternow.com. That's 1-855-REALWTR or buyrealwaternow.com. Order now, 1-855-REALWTR or buyrealwaternow.com.
Free Talk Live.
This is what petty bureaucrats do. They protect their turf. And if you can tell me the operable difference between governments, city, state, federal, whatever they might be, and the most successful gang in a given area, I'd love to hear the difference. I just don't know what the difference is. Yes, government has a funny way of appointing its dons.
Elections.
But that's really it. That's all I can come up with. It's a gang that's figured out, hey, if we let people participate, if they have a vote, that is statistically an insignificant fact that they have a vote, but we let them have one, then they'll feel like they're part of us, and then they can do whatever they want. They cannot pave a road for 43 years and then have everybody claim that without the government, we wouldn't be able to pave roads.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com to receive our usually weekly news updates by email. Plus, we have a Twitter account at twitter.freetalklive.com, and you can follow us on the decentralized Mastodon platform at toot.freetalklive.com. So please follow us at toot.freetalklive.com and sign up for our emails at news.freetalklive.com. Bitcoin.com has launched a trading platform at local.bitcoin.com, allowing you to buy or sell Bitcoin Cash via dozens of payment methods like PayPal, Venmo, bank deposit, remittances, or meeting in person with cash. There are no ID requirements to sign up for and use the site, and all communications between buyers and sellers are encrypted. Finally, a global trading platform that respects your privacy. Visit local.bitcoin.com to get started trading Bitcoin Cash. local.bitcoin.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, like freedom, 855-450-3733. We have the Discord call-in line rooms at discord.lrn.fm. We're looking briefly at the Democratic National Convention and how embarrassingly bad it's been. Now, does anyone know if the Republicans are going to do this online thing, or are they going to also, are they actually going to have a physical reality convention? Do you know?
I believe that they're going to have an online component, definitely, but I don't know as far as how many people are going to be at the convention. I think it's in St. Louis. They've moved the location several times.
Because
so
they can't find a place that's willing to have it, I would imagine, right? Because all these places are canceling conventions, which is what happened with the Young Americans for Liberty convention that you were supposed to go to like a week ago.
Yeah.
They just city of Dallas, the mayor just decided to weigh in 4 days before they were going to have the convention and said, nope, you're not having your convention. Done deal. So
I'm not looking forward to the conventions here. I'm looking forward to the debate.
Terrible. Conventions are awful. Why anyone would subject themselves to actually watching them, I just don't know. I mean, I did watch a little bit of the Libertarian Party's convention just to see how bad it would be. Because I know conventions are boring as hell. There's all this so-called business that goes on where they like argue over bylaws. Like, oh, we need to put an and in here and get rid of the comma, replace that with a semicolon and change the and to an or. It's that kind of stuff for hours. With people just arguing over what this should say and what that should say and what the party should stand for, and it's just so awful.
Even as
somebody,
maybe it's in Charlotte.
Some of the Republican convention,
yeah, held in Charlotte, North Carolina, in August.
Well, like you said, they probably have moved it around a few times, so who knows where it's actually going to occur. But just to see how bad it actually was, and you know, you expect a lot of infighting at these conventions. Certainly, that happens at the Libertarian convention. Obviously, it's going to happen at the other ones as well, whether it be between the Bernie people and the Joe Biden people or whatever. And so you definitely had that here, but without the ability to like physically shut down somebody's microphone, and there weren't, it's just a totally different thing. Like the real life convention, people would stand in a long line waiting to actually physically get to a microphone. Here, that's not the case. Everybody is on this online platform. It might make it easier to comment. It might make it so more comments happen, which means it'll take even longer than it normally would. And so anyway, I wanted to play a little clip, and it's kudos to Vincent from Questioning Authority, who has he's moved out of the Keene area. He used to host the show with us here. He was going to Keene State College, and he just graduated. Cool. Lucky him. He just got out. But he was sharing this with me last night. It's a minute-long clip of just the kind of the quality of this convention. Now, this is not a video show that we're doing. We're on the radio, so we're going to try to describe to you. I'm going to play this for you, Tyler. You're the one sitting right across from the screen. I just want you to comment on the quality of this clip here.
Oh no. Oh, this already looks cringy. We've got a green screen background, clearly.
So there's a, and I don't know who the performer is. There's a man in a kind of a flowing, I'm not going to call
cape.
It a dress.
He looks like a Dracula costume or something.
There's an older guy on a guitar. I'm sure that somebody from, you know, the 70s or whatever. I just don't know who it is. Not
you
Eric
wish
Clapton.
This is a music video from the 1960s. I mean,
yes. There are actually some better videos from the 1960s. There's better quality.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're like not even a minute in, and I can tell you this looks like high school AV quality.
Yeah. Right. For the budget, for the budget that the Democratic National Committee must have and would normally spend on a convention, this is like you said, high school quality. You can get quality like this out of your local public access channel.
Mm-hmm.
Right. They made fun of Clint Eastwood for talking to a chair. This is worse.
Oh man.
Yeah. So this is, you know, one of these intermissions, right, where there's not actually anything, you know, convention-like going on. They brought on a musical performer. I'm sure he's well-known these days. I just don't know who it is. Brought on some probably well-known musical performer.
But he was singing an old song.
Singing a classic, you know, protest, what people consider protest songs, right? So they had some oldies that they were playing during the convention, and Yeah, that's just a little clip of the what was should have been one of the higher quality aspects of the production, because otherwise you're just watching a Zoom meeting, which has no production quality to it whatsoever. There's a person on a stage. The stage looks fine or whatever. The Zoom meeting looks like any old Zoom meeting. And then there's this.
This looks phoned in really bad.
So bad. And of course,
it should be a Super Bowl halftime show.
Well, right. Yeah. And if you had a convention with people, then a performer would have the energy of the performance that they were doing. This, of course, has no energy whatsoever because it's just a guy on a green screen with some man behind a camera, and they're filming this, and some kids, you know, putting together the elements in whatever the live mixing software is that they've got, and that's it. That's their production. Mm-hmm. And there's the guy with the guitar who's probably in another room.
You know,
entirely.
Though, it might have been worse if people had showed up, because part of me thinks that they're taking advantage of the fact that they probably couldn't have filled a room with enough people to make it look like people were interested.
It's a good point. Yeah, you got to pay. If they were paying for you know, their attendees, then they don't have to pay for as many of them if it's an online.
A lot of the attendees convention. Are up in that 70-80 range, and those folks shouldn't be out in big groups.
Yeah, so it's just really bad. The quality is just in the toilet. And this is like what I was saying about production quality in general. Now, mind you, I don't watch these Hollywood nightly TV shows, right? Like, what are they called?
The Late Night Show.
Tonight Show. Yeah. Late Show. The Late, Late, Late Show or whatever. There's all these different shows out there. The hosts have changed over the years, but some of them, you know, still have the same show name. And so some of these things are still being produced, but they're not being produced in front of a live studio audience. And they're not even being produced from inside the studio, because a lot of these people are part of the propaganda mission of propagandizing people, like, this is serious. Look, folks, I love my audience. I love you guys, but this is serious. It's so serious. I don't even want to come in and see my crew. I'm taking this just as seriously as you should. I'm staying home. I'm going to do my Colbert show or whatever from my den. You're going to see me growing my hair out. You're going to see me unshaven. This is the real me. I'm real.
Because we don't have razors at my house.
We're all staying home, and you need to do what we're doing, right? So the idea is to project this as normal, that this is now the new way of doing things. Well, that also means that you don't have the production capabilities that you would have in a professional studio. Like, much in the same way, Mark, that this show sounds a little better when we're in this studio than it does if we're sitting outside at a campground, or if you're in Saipan with the remote kit, which doesn't have the same level of equipment. It just doesn't have the same capabilities. It doesn't have it. It's a fraction of the cost.
Sitting there with cheap microphones versus these RE23s.
And it doesn't mean that the show is less entertaining, and it doesn't mean that these hosts, and again, I haven't watched any of this. I've just seen a little clips here and there, like, oh my God, this is what people are watching now. But so it doesn't mean that they're not funny or that the scripts aren't any good. Maybe they still are. But it sure doesn't look the same.
Right.
It doesn't have any polish to it whatsoever. No one cares. It's like they don't have the equipment to care, and so why bother caring anymore? And it's just like they're cranking out whatever content they can, and, you know, good for them. I mean, I'm not trying to knock the fact that they're continuing to do their show, but it's like, what is being produced that's actually high quality on the television marketplace these days?
I don't know. I'm not watching TV. Netflix.
A lot of people are watching. You know, a lot of people are watching TV. They're watching more TV probably now than they ever have. I mean, I presume the dramatic productions are going to continue when they continue, and they will, like, I mean, I presume, like, The Walking Dead's not going to come back and everybody's going to be wearing masks in the middle of, like, a fictional TV show. So presumably we'll still be able to, like, escape into these fictional TV worlds without having masks interrupting
everything. Yeah, but I bet it's going to come out slower, too. I feel like I heard an interview recently where an actor was saying that in order to film the scenes now, they have just the cameraman and just the actors scene will come out, and everyone else is in another room. And it's like, and they got to wipe everything down before somebody else comes out. So, you know, all of your favorite shows, you know, aren't going to be coming out with new episodes right off the bat anyway.
It's
going to
be slower.
Yeah, a lot slower production. Yeah.
And I know they postponed The Walking Dead, which is a huge television show, very popular. I think it's on season 10. They have had one more episode to go that was supposed to come out, like, in early March, and they claimed that they couldn't finish it. Like, they couldn't send the editor
in. Our show about the global pandemic had to be delayed because of a global pandemic.
They like, couldn't send the editor into Warner Brothers, you know, to do the job, which is, editing's a single-person job for the most part anyway. Mm-hmm. You don't want to have too many cooks in that kitchen.
Yeah.
But they claimed they couldn't get it done. Oh, we need more effects or whatever, and we can't get it done. It still hasn't aired.
Yeah, that's weird.
It's maybe October going to be before that thing comes out.
I can't say I'm happy that the Black Widow movie from Marvel has been backed off to November.
Great. That's another question. When's the first major release movie going to come out? Because they keep pushing them back. It was supposed to be Tenet was supposed to come out this summer, and it's been pushed back, and other movies have been pushed back by like a year. So,
are movie theaters still going to be a thing?
Well, that's a whole other question. The toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE like freedom. You can join us. Your comments on whatever's on your mind are welcome. This is Free Talk Live.
Remember when you first heard about Bitcoin? How long did it take you to realize this little project
Internet problem.
Would soon change the world? Do you kind of wish you had gotten involved sooner? Well, now is your chance to be part of the next revolution in money. Intercoin is working to finally make crypto go mainstream. It's designed to be scalable enough to support everyday payments and even elections without the state. Bitcoin was originally supposed to be a peer-to-peer cash system, the way we would all pay one another without having to trust any third party. But instead, over time, it mostly became a store of value. That's because every 10 minutes, the Bitcoin network must put all transactions into a block, and that block can only hold so much. If crypto is to become mainstream, for everyone to use it in everyday payments, we need a new architecture, one that's as secure as Bitcoin while being far more scalable. Check out intercoin.org to find out more, and maybe pick up some of those coins for yourself.
Is oral health important to you? If you don't like your own teeth, fresh breath, or kissing people, then by all means, stop listening. Several years ago, I met Jessica Armand, founder and CEO of My Magic Mud, and I became passionate about the product that she created and never want to live without it. It's clinically proven to whiten teeth, but I find it does much more. They want you to love My Magic Mud as much as I do, so they're giving you a money-back guarantee plus 20% off. Go to MyMagicMud.com and use coupon code FTL20 at checkout. MyMagicMud.com, FTL20.
LRN.fm now has a Discord. Discord is a free text and voice chat platform, and we now have our own server with a bunch of channels at discord.lrn.fm. You can join other listeners as they chat about various things during our live shows, or anytime, day or night. Discord software is available cross-platform, so you can have it on whatever device you want and take your chats anywhere. Join our Discord at discord.lrn.fm. That's discord.lrn.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
The big night. I'm Lisa LaSera, Fox News. The Democratic National Committee set to kick off its final night of the convention in less than an hour, with Joe Biden set to formally accept the presidential nomination.
Last night was about painting the country as in a state of chaos and crisis and blaming President Trump. Tonight will be about Joe Biden trying to establish himself as the tested leader who can right the ship. The campaign says Biden will deliver a positive vision hinging on his core belief that the country can be united, and he will lay out a plan. So far, keynote speakers largely skirted specific policy talk, mostly selling the candidates. Taped testimonials from supporters served to highlight policies the ticket wants to tackle, like health care, immigration, and gun control. Biden's speech will likely focus on the pandemic and the economy.
Fox's Jackie Heinrich. President Trump taking his message today to Pennsylvania, right near where Biden lived as a child.
He left. He abandoned Pennsylvania. He abandoned Scranton. He was here for a short period of time, and he didn't even know it. And today, it's amazing. It goes around in a circle. He still doesn't know it.
Though the president did say he hopes Biden does well in his speech tonight, but he says he wants Biden to tell the truth, and he says Biden will do a lot better if he does. Attorney General William Barr says the Justice Department will again seek the death penalty for Boston Marathon bomber Dzhokhar Tsarnaev, taking the matter to the Supreme Court. Barr telling the Associated Press, "We will do whatever is necessary." Last month, an appeals court upheld upheld Tsarnaev's conviction but ordered a new trial over what sentence he should receive. Former Trump aide Steve Bannon has been released from custody after pleading not guilty today to charges he and three others defrauded donors trying to fund a southern border wall. Earlier today, President Trump, who has distanced himself from Bannon in recent years, said he knew nothing about the project. Bannon has until September 3rd to meet the conditions of his $5 million bond. America is listening to Fox News.
In 2020, small businesses have had to be resilient. Small businesses also need to be more efficient than ever. And that means every hire is critical. Indeed is here to help. Indeed.com is the number one job site in the world because Indeed gets you the best people fast. Unlike other sites, Indeed gives you full control and payment flexibility over your hiring. You only pay for what you need. You can pause your account at any time, and there are no long-term contracts. Plus, Indeed provides powerful tools to make your search that much easier, like sponsored jobs, which are shown to be 3.5 times more likely to result in a hire. With 73% of online job seekers visiting Indeed each month, Indeed is going to get you the important hire you need, just like they have for over 3 million businesses. Right now, Indeed is offering our listeners a free $75 credit to boost your job post, which means more quality candidates will see it fast. Try Indeed out with a free $75 credit at Indeed.com/Fox. This is their best offer available anywhere. Go right now to Indeed.com/Fox. Terms and conditions apply. Offer valid through September 30th.
A federal judge has rejected President Trump's bid to stop Manhattan's district attorney from obtaining his financial records.
President Trump's attorneys argued the subpoena was too broad and was issued in bad faith. U.S. District Judge Victor Marrero disagreed and tossed the case, saying the president failed to show complying would pose an undue burden. The ruling comes after the U.S. Supreme Court rejected President Trump's claim of absolute immunity from state prosecution. Bloomberg reports Trump attorney Jay Sekulow is vowing to appeal the decision. The Manhattan DA's office has declined to comment. Rachel Sutherland, Fox News.
The Justice Department asking the Supreme Court to review a lower court ruling that the president is not allowed to block people from his personal Twitter account because it amounts to viewpoint discrimination. A discouraging sign in the job market.
The number of people applying for unemployment benefits increased last week, a sign that layoffs may have picked up this month. There were 1.1 million new claims in the week ending August 15th. The number of new claims in the previous week had dipped below a million for the first time since late March. The number of people continuing to receive benefits, which is figured for the previous week, August 8th, declined to 14.8 million. It's an improvement, though still dramatically high. The number of Americans seeking benefits in a single week peaked at nearly 7 million in late March. Janico Silda, Fox News.
You've heard of genetically modified food, but what about genetically modified mosquitoes? Sometime next year, they will be released in the Florida Keys to try to combat insect-borne diseases like dengue fever and the Zika virus. A biotech company is set to release millions of male mosquitoes that would breed with females, but because of the modification, their young would not survive, which would in theory reduce the number of mosquitoes that would transmit those illnesses. I'm Lee Silasera, and this is Fox News.
It's the Onion Radio News. Raccoon leaders call for the loosening of garbage can lids. This is Doyle Redland reporting. In a 4 a.m. speech at the group's annual Washington, D.C. convention this morning, North American Raccoon Federation President Bristletail called upon homeowners to loosen the lids of their garbage cans, providing the ring-tailed mammals with greater access to discarded food scraps during nocturnal scavenging.
Every time you seal a standard 30-gallon garbage can, as many as 6 raccoons are forced to go without their necessary daily supply of congealed baked beans, rancid cottage cheese chunks, and moldy cantaloupe rinds.
The 26-pound varmint closed his speech with a stern warning that without raccoons, possums could take over the world. Doyle Redland for The Onion Radio News, online at theonion.com.
This is The Onion News Network.
It's Free Talk Live. We're kicking off the third hour here. You can bring up anything that you want. Our number is 855-450-FREE like freedom. That's 855-450-3733. With you in the studio, it's Ian.
Tyler.
And Mark.
We're going to continue. Of course, we'll take your calls and thoughts. We're going to go to the Discord lines here in a moment, where you can sound almost like you're sitting here with us. Go to discord.lrn.fm and join one of the top four rooms. You'll see there they're called the on-air call-in lines. And once we see you in there, we'll join you, and then you'll be able to hear us. And we can talk to you on the radio about things you want to discuss, whether it be whatever's going on with these Democratic or Republican national conventions. I don't know when the Republican one is scheduled for, but the Democratic one appears to be wrapping up as we speak. There appear to be a bunch of Democrats in a pre-produced sort of, multi-clip kind of thing where they're intercutting between different interviews of these different Democrats, and they're all talking about what they want to see happen a year from now once the Democrats take back over the White House and bring things back. They've got Andrew Yang now speaking because it's important for them to bring out as many of the former presidential candidates and have them throw their weight behind, even though they were all attacking one another not, 8 or 9 months ago.
That was the debate. That's just a campaign.
Yeah. Isn't that what Harris said
basically
recently? All right. So we continue here. Let's go to Gene the Christian Anarchist, and you're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Gene.
Yeah, the insanity is starting to get to me. I'm just I'm pretty upset by everything I see going on.
What's changing? Because it's been pretty insane for a while. Is it just worse, or is it the same level of insanity that it's just now getting to you?
Every time I think that it's gone as far as it can go, they push it one step farther. Mm. And I'm about ready to just go to Mars. You know, when that ship is ready to blast off, I'm going to see if Elon Musk will put me on it. Yeah,
you know, I feel it's the same way. I mean, it's just absolutely ridiculous out there. But was there something specific that you saw that made you want to call in?
Yeah, I want to bring this point up. I've number of times have brought up all the scientific studies that show that masks do not prevent the spread of viruses, And of course, this is just science, right? But people are throwing science out the window when it disagrees with their position.
Yeah. So calling their position science at the same time.
Right. And the studies have shown, and now obviously we know masks prevent people from spitting on each other or, spraying on each other. And that's true. I mean, you can't deny that fact. However, the studies still show that that does not help prevent the spread of viruses. I mean, it's going to help to some extent, but the masks have been shown to be ineffective, probably due to the fact that people are always touching them all the time.
Mm-hmm.
So that minimizes, that probably counteracts the effect of, stopping the sprays. So anyway, the scientific studies have shown for over a decade that masks don't stop the spread of viruses. So mm-hmm. now all of a sudden, they've convinced most of the planet that they have to wear a mask because of this virus. And the insanity is crazy, but now they're taking it one step further.
Oh God! Now what?
I couldn't believe this picture that I'm looking at of the governor of Maine,
mm-hmm.
and I haven't fact checked this, and I sure as hell hope this is a Snopes or something, but or a joke. But the governor of Maine is demanding that servers wear a collar that looks like a dog's bite collar, so that they don't bite their rear leg, when they've got a wound.
I'm glad you brought this one up because that's the same story I have pulled up here, Gene. I had it in my show prep tonight. From what I can tell, some of the reports on this are a bit exaggerated. Now, that's not to say it isn't ridiculous, okay? This is a very ridiculous news story, but the photograph that they show here, for instance, on InfoWars, which has covered this story, is of a attractive server at a restaurant wearing what appears to be an upside-down lampshade on her head as she's got... as she's got the, meals that she's delivering to her customers. And that's not exactly what they're describing here. So the story from InfoWars does cite Maine Public Radio. So if you go to mainepublic.org, that's where this story came from. So there is some digging you can do to find this. The Mills administration, that's the governor there in Maine, has updated prevention checklists for several types of businesses under stage 3 of the state's reopening plans, which affect restaurants. And most of the updates are a few additions or clarifications. For example, front of house staff in restaurants who choose to wear face shields must now wear them upside down so they are attached at the collar instead of the forehead so that their breath is directed upwards, not down.
Science.
Yeah.
So well, that's
You know, but I wouldn't doubt it because these people are so crazy. And we're talking mainly about the people on the left now that are demanding these ridiculous health issues, health precautions that have been shown to not work. But now that you can go to the MAGA crowd and they're just as crazy and wacky on the right side because they support, you know, they're on this big back the blue nonsense, you know, even though it's been proven how ineffective police are at number one, keeping you safe, and how they're very effective at brutalizing people against their rights. They're very good at violating
the very same cops that they love to just laud are the very same ones who are going to be enforcing these mask ordinances.
So this division between left and right is just perfect for keeping everybody in their own little insanity. So you've got the insanity of the right, you've got the insanity of the left, and they both feed on each other and laugh at each other. And, you know, the right laughs at the left laughs at the right, and they hate each other. And it's just, when you can actually look at this with a sane mind and you see what's going on, it drives the sane mind insane.
Yeah.
Because that's where I'm at today. You know, I'm looking at this and I'm going, how did this get to this point? Where is there something in the water? You know, they've been saying the fluoride all these years, and I've been poo-pooing the fluoride. You know, fluoride ain't good for you, but I didn't think that it had anything to do with controlling your mind. But you know what? I may have to rethink that situation. Maybe it is the fluoride. There's got to be some explanation.
It's just obedience training. That's all it is. I mean, it's been decades in the making. They've been preparing for this for a long time. Now, they didn't know this was going to come here and now, I suspect, unless this really is some big big plot. I'm not going to give them that much credit. But, man, they sure are excited about making these changes. They know this is an opportunity. In fact, I've got another story about some of the things that these know-it-alls have been saying about how this is a big chance to change things so-called for the better, and that now people are susceptible to large sweeping changes, essentially, and they're going to do everything they can to take
never let a crisis go to waste,
right, to take advantage of that. So this is just decades of obedience training, Gene. That's what people have been trained for in the government schools. That's what they've been trained for with things like business licenses. You got to ask permission in order to do things. Oh, you want to have a protest, make sure you get your permit. So there's been this whole ask permission mentality that's been in place here in the United States for a long time, and so this is just the next step of that. This is just those same people looking to government agents for direction in a what they consider to be a scary situation, and they will do whatever they're told.
But they call that freedom.
Do they still call it freedom?
I don't think people even talk about freedom anymore.
No, no, Mark, I did see somebody shared a photograph of freedom masks. So you can go to, you can go to Walmart. You can go to Walmart and you can buy masks with like freedom emblazoned across the front of it.
And the irony.
I don't think that's done ironically, but I don't know. It's Jesus.
Well, it's freedom to get out of your house, I guess.
Was it called freedom when you had a hall pass back in elementary school? No.
I would have called, when I was in prison, I would have called probation freedom, sure.
Yeah. It's only a difference by degree.
It's all in perspective, I guess.
It is. Gene, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate it. That's Gene the Christian Anarchist. You want to chat with him directly? He's on our Discord server. He's there often. You can go to discord.lrn.fm. And even if you don't want to call in, it's cool. Still a cool place to hang out and chat with other Free Talk Live listeners there. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE like freedom. That's 855-450-3733. You can bring up what you want here. In fact, Mark, you've got a story about people leaving the cities. They're exiting. They're going to other places. And it's not just one coast. It's both of them, I think you said. You can share that story coming up here. Your calls, your thoughts, welcome. Bring up anything that's on your mind. Take control of the airwaves here on Free Talk Live.
Divvy's been a pretty good investment for Free Talk Live. Their ad campaign started in September 2019, and from mid-March to mid-July, the values soared by 10 times. It's not too late. Divvy's new wallet hasn't even released yet, and other things are happening that I can't even say on the radio. If you want to invest and potentially do well, go to DivvyProject.org. I can tell you that FTL is deepening its partnership with the guys from DivvyProject.org. Past performance is not an indication of future profit. DivvyProject.org. D-I-V-I Project.org.
Do you want more businesses accepting Bitcoin Cash and Dash? Now, with AnyPay, you earn passive income for every purchase at those businesses. Finally, a financial incentive to spread Bitcoin Cash and Dash. You made it happen, so you receive the rewards. Download the AnyPay Cash Register app and add your cryptocurrency wallet addresses. Then, install it at a real-life business and tell us what you did at AnyPayInc.com. AnyPayInc.com.
Did you know you can support freedom of speech just by visiting shop.freetalklive.com? You'll see links to Walmart, LoveJava, Newegg, and more. Every day, Free Talk Live is at the forefront of the Liberty Movement as the biggest liberty-oriented talk show in the world, giving you a platform to be heard on any topic. Get listener-only specials without doing anything other than an extra click. Visit shop.freetalklive.com. Use the links and buy what you'd be buying anyway. Take action now. Save and support freedom. Visit shop.freetalklive.com. It's shop.freetalklive.com. News from news.bitcoin.com. Chinese banks limit customers' ability to buy gold. Chinese flooding and potential dam collapse threatens many Bitcoin operations. Withdrawals from crypto exchanges increase, indicating perhaps more people are holding their coin for themselves. Tentative agreement met to stabilize Bitcoin Cash mining in conjunction with the currency's third birthday. Bitcoin.com is your source for getting started with cryptocurrencies, getting a wallet, buying Bitcoin Cash, mining, and all the latest cryptocurrency news at news.bitcoin.com.
The political world is a maddening cesspool of corruption and lies. Nobody tells the truth. Nobody keeps campaign promises. Nobody obeys the Constitution. Nobody puts the people first. How can we ever escape this web of tyranny? Vote for nobody.
Hi, my name is Nobody. I'm running for governor of New Hampshire because nobody knows how to live your life better than you do, and nobody deserves that kind of power. I want to put you back in control of your money, your lifestyle, your work, your body, and your life. Nobody should rule you but you. New Hampshire convicts many people of so-called crimes that should never have been prosecuted. If elected, I will pardon every victimless crime in New Hampshire history. This includes drug, gambling, prostitution, gun, and driving offenses. Nobody should have a criminal record when they have not harmed anybody.
Wouldn't it be nice to have nobody telling you what to do? Learn more at electnobody.com. electnobody.com.
The LRN.fm social media channels have been revamped. We've eliminated Facebook and focused on other platforms like Twitter and Mastodon, the decentralized alternative to Twitter. On our accounts, you'll find posts from multiple LRN.fm show hosts together in one place. Follow us on Twitter at twitter.lrn.fm, or better yet, move to the decentralized Mastodon social media platform at toot.lrn.fm, toot.lrn.fm. I think you'll like it.
There are basically two types of advertising: direct response and branding. Radio's great for direct response with its low cost to listener ratio, but audio can't be beat for branding, which is a longer term endeavor. You want to be the first thing that someone thinks of when they think about your product or service. If you have a local business that you want kept top of mind in your community, call the station. If you need national reach, Free Talk Live's got around 200 radio stations, millions of monthly listening sessions, can suit all budgets, and if we don't think we're right for you, we'll tell you. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
Join the LRN.fm Discord for live chat 24/7 at discord.lrn.fm. That's discord.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial in, toll free, bring up whatever you want here. Our number is 855-450-FREE, like freedom. That's 855-450-3733. Apparently the political warmonger types, the powermongers, they got a name for this whole thing, this COVID-19, what we consider to be madness, what we consider to be insane, what we were just talking with Gene about, all this
you know, these new rules and this new so-called new normal, which is ridiculous and very anti-human, in my opinion, and sad. You were just looking, Tyler, at a photograph of what I'd only heard described, because we were just talking, I think, yesterday or the day before that on this show about kids going back to school and how sad of a situation that it was, how just dismal and depressing it sounded. You actually have a photograph of what appears to be some sort of a lunchroom situation with kids sitting at, how would you describe it?
Like 6 feet apart across the table, 6 feet apart from each person. So you've got two kids to like a long bench table.
Right.
And they're just sad. And
you sitting on the equal, on the diagonal.
Right. Kitty corner to each other. And just like, it just looks dystopian and
so
sad.
Crazy.
Yeah. And it's like, why would you even want to send your kid to school in that situation?
Yeah, you have no options.
Right, I guess, yeah.
You it's either don't care about your kids or you have no options.
Yeah.
And you're desperate.
Well, now it's been a couple generations where public school is the norm, right? So a lot of these parents, they don't even know what else they could do.
Right. This is the way it's always been, and now there's this new thing that they're shoving down your throat, and it's like, well, take this.
Yep.
This is what you get.
Yep, this is what you get, and there's nothing you can do about it.
Well, there is. You could figure out something, right? Like if you really wanted to. Mm-hmm. I understand, you know, they're single moms and they have a tough time or whatever. I get it. I'm not saying that, you know, that the options are great, but there's got to be something else. Like maybe get together with other single parents and come up with some sort of
school co-op.
Yeah, right. Like something like that.
That's certainly a possibility. They exist all over. And those are low cost and, you know, an option.
Right. With enough of a drive, you can figure something out. They say necessity is the mother of inventions. Well, now is the time to get your kids out of government school. If you've been waiting for an excuse or a reason, this is as good a time as any. They're actually talking about what this so-called Great Reset is. Have you guys heard about this, the Great Reset?
Yeah, I have heard that term.
I haven't.
Okay, so it's the first time I came across it was this article. You know, in my Google News feed on my phone, I get articles about Bitcoin and cryptocurrency because I'm into that stuff, right? So this headline is from Cointelegraph, and it asks, what role will crypto play during the Great Reset? And they actually get into talking about who's promoting this Great Reset. Well, we'll tell you a little bit about it here. The global pandemic, massive and worldwide protests, job automation, environmental issues, and geopolitical tensions are just a few of the challenges facing humanity today. Amid the chaos, keystone global institutions and bureaucrats have openly discussed the present day as an opportunity to remake the world. The Great Reset, as the plan has been called, represents a radical initiative by world leaders, many of whom are unelected, to transform the global economy. Who's behind this terminology? A group called the World Economic Forum.
Yeah, I've heard of them.
You've heard of them. These are, you know, the bigwigs. These are the Bilderberg types, right? For instance, they claim there's an urgent need for global stakeholders to manage the direct consequences of what the International Monetary Fund has called the Great Lockdown. As though lockdowns are great. I think they mean big, right? Like great as in big.
The Great Wall of China isn't necessarily a great wall. Yeah. It is just large.
Referring to the quarantines and social distancing practices implemented to contain the pandemic, or at least so they say, at a WEF meeting in early June, the world's most powerful business leaders, government officials, and activists first announced the proposal to reset the global economy in the aftermath of the COVID-19 lockdown. Terms like that don't sound very good to freedom-loving people.
When they start talking about getting involved in the global economy, every time these people get involved in the global economy, we all get screwed.
Mm-hmm. Right, because they want to get a piece, a big piece, of whatever money happens to be left. The WEF, World Economic Forum, sees a, quote, unique window of opportunity to shape the recovery. The Great Reset will inform the, quote, future state of global relations, the direction of national economies, the priorities of societies, the nature of business models, and the management of the global commons, unquote. In short, the Great Reset represents a new social contract for the world. You remember signing that last one, right?
Oh, right. Yep,
the new social contract.
This one's going to be even better.
I'm not signing this one either.
So, yeah, I mean, these people are ready to shake up everything.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, global relations, national economies, the priorities of societies, the nature of business models. I mean, they're talking about
the total, nature of business models.
Yeah, total change.
Writing for The Hill, Justin Haskins calls the Great Reset, quote, the most ambitious and radical plan the world has seen in more than a generation.
Right. The one before that was the Communist Manifesto.
Prince Charles was at the meeting, and he said, quote, we have a golden opportunity to seize something good from this crisis. Its unprecedented shockwaves may well make people more receptive to big visions of change. It's an opportunity we have never had before. And may never have again, unquote.
Can I put on my tinfoil hat for a minute and tell you guys what I think is going to happen?
Yeah.
What's going on, I think, is that the world elites need to shuffle the deck because things are getting kind of out of hand as far as like debt and the lack of GDP growth in all these developed countries. So basically, they're going to shuffle the deck. They're going to mix things around. It's going to be very confusing to the normal person. But what's going to happen to us is our money is going to be worth a lot less than it is now. And there's going to be some new pyramid scheme that you can jump on to try and get ahead of the curve or whatever. But in the meantime, all this stuff with COVID and everything, all of these measures they're taking and this new precedence they're setting and all these rights they're violating, I think that's just a grab while they have the chance because they know as soon as your money's not worth as much and it's going to take a lot more to keep your family fed, people are going to be a lot angrier. And it's going to be easier to keep them in line if they've already got tracking in place and they've got you pegged in your home and you're too afraid to leave. You know, you're not. What are you going to do at that point?
Yeah, don't forget the sort of destruction of cultural, you know, groups, mixing people up. The global elites have had, you know, wanted to see their immigration going on in Europe and these sorts of things, and it's gone very poorly up to this point.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, I feel like a lot of that, you know. I'm all for open borders, freedom of association, right, when the conditions are right. But if you're just busing people in or, you know, boating people in from another country and trying to integrate them into society, it makes everybody scared of each other. Nobody trusts each other. And a lot of these people, you know, have trouble, like, understanding that in order for a society to work is we all have to share the same underlying values. We can't all believe in different things and you know, and assume that these institutions are still going to treat us all equally.
Well, now they're making everybody afraid of everybody. It's not just that people are afraid of immigrants or Muslims or, you know, the way it was a decade ago, which of course was irrational on most people's parts.
Right.
Now they're completely irrationally afraid of absolutely everyone they come in contact with.
Everybody else. Yeah.
And that is one of the most damaging parts about this is now everybody's the potential enemy, which, you know, now we've got snitching that's happening at a level that's never happened before. It's very disturbing. And there's more coming up here because apparently the details of this so-called Great Reset.
You have the details.
What? No. Many of them won't even be rolled out until they meet again in January of 2021. So it sounds like they're meeting twice a year, once in June or July or whatever, and then once in January. So they're still plotting this World Economic Group, this World Economic Forum. 855-450-FREE, like freedom. You can join us here on the radio. As we're also hopefully get to talk about the people leaving the cities, because that's another change that is undergoing right now. It's Free Talk Live.
News from news.bitcoin.com. Chinese banks limit customers' ability to buy gold. Chinese flooding and potential dam collapse threatens many Bitcoin operations. Withdrawals from crypto exchanges increase, indicating perhaps more people are holding their coin for themselves. Tentative agreement met to stabilize Bitcoin Cash mining in conjunction with the currency's third birthday. Bitcoin.com is your source for getting started with cryptocurrencies, getting a wallet, buying Bitcoin Cash, mining, and all the latest cryptocurrency news at news.bitcoin.com. Divi's been a pretty good investment for Free Talk Live. Their ad campaign started in September 2019, and from mid-March to mid-July, the values soared by 10 times. It's not too late. Divi's new wallet hasn't even released yet, and other things are happening that I can't even say on the radio. If you want to invest and potentially do well, go to DiviProject.org. I can tell you that FTL is deepening its partnership with the guys from DiviProject.org. Past performance is not an indication of future profit. DiviProject.org. DiviProject.org.
Is spreading the message of liberty, cryptocurrency, and peace around the globe worth $2 per month to you? As you may already know, in addition to our internet feed, LRN.FM broadcasts on free-to-air satellite across North and Central America, as well as Sub-Saharan Africa. And we've been available on satellite for free 24/7 since 2010. The LRN.FM free-to-air satellite signal is reaching some of the most oppressive regimes in the world, and there's no doubt our ideas are making an impact. You can learn more about the channel's impact by watching the 3-minute video at fund.lrn.fm. If you'd like to help free minds globally with our ideas of liberty, cryptocurrency, and peace, you can donate as little as $2 per month via fund.lrn.fm. You can help us continue and expand our satellite broadcast to multiple continents. Visit fund.lrn.fm today, and thank you for your help. Don't forget to share the link on social media. That's fund.lrn.fm.
Looking for a great real estate investment? Consider New Hampshire, which is ground zero for the Liberty Movement. Your first call should be to Mark Worden from Porcupine Real Estate. He's more than just a real estate agent. He's your New Hampshire concierge. Where are the best places to live? Do you want farm, city, the burbs, or forest? Do you want a duplex or multifamily building so that renters pay your mortgage? There are homes in all price ranges in New Hampshire, and Mark can help with financing too. Invest in liberty and property. Mark Worden can help.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
There are lots of ways to listen to Free Talk Live. Our podcast has been around since podcasts began, and now the FTL feed is loaded with content besides our full show archives. Did you know that we make it easy for you to customize your podcast subscriptions? We have different feeds, one that includes only our full shows, one with just the Daily Digest, and our main feed that includes everything. You decide what you listen to. It's quick and easy to customize your feeds at feeds.freetalklive.com. That's feeds.freetalklive.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you are?
There is no video or audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make...
Wait.
You gotta go. Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from?
Because you scared me. What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
Live video of our key New Hampshire-based shows is streamed on DLive. Please follow and share at dlive.lrn.fm. That's dlive.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial in toll free. Bring up what you want. Our number is 855-450 free like freedom. That's 855-450-3733. And Free Talk Live here brought to you by Divvy. From mid-March to mid-July, Divvy, the new easy-to-use cryptocurrency we've promoted here on Free Talk Live, has had increased in value by over 10 times in that time frame this year. Amazing. And of course, Divvy could continue to go up. That's certainly what their intention is behind the scenes there at Divvy. They're working on a brand new wallet, and they've released the beta version to a private beta. And it was at the same time, or around the same time, where the price started to go up. Now, will the price continue to go up if they release the wallet fully, or when they release the wallet fully? I don't know. Can't predict the future, but at Free Talk Live, we're happy with our decision to hook up with Divvy a year ago. And you can go to DivvyProject.org and begin earning Divvy by starting a masternode or staking Divvy over at DivvyProject.org and learn more about it. DIVIProject.org. As we continue here, we're going to take your calls and thoughts, but I just want to share a little bit more about this so-called Great Reset. That is what the World Economic Forum, a forum of, you know, big business, big politicians, big
wigs.
Yeah,
how do you get invited to this? I'd like to go.
Probably have to own a bank.
You got to know the right people, Mark, and it's a big club, but we're not in it.
Yeah, no, they're never going to let Free Talk Live in it.
So they're talking about reshaping the entire world, changing the state of global relations, national economies, priorities of societies, the nature of business models, and the management, they say, of the global commons. They're talking about writing a new social contract, which, of course, no one ever wrote down in the first place, so it's all a bunch of BS. But regardless, it's being praised from thehill.com to Prince Charles, and they say here that many of the details aren't even available yet. They're going to meet again in Davos, Switzerland in January. And
lots of great things happen for humanity in Davos.
In Davos. they got big plans for what is described here in the Cointelegraph article as a new world order. And, of course, a lot of people have been been using this terminology of New World Order for a long
time.
The
Great Reset sounds remarkably like a New World Order.
Mm-hmm. This looks like a New World Order. I mean, everything has changed in just the last several months, and most of it changed within the first several weeks.
Yeah. Some of it tells me, something tells me, though, that, like, yeah, the people that are actually in charge aren't going to change. There's no, new world order.
Well, it'll be the same old goons, mm-hmm. but the order will be different.
Right.
The things that are expected of people, the things that people are told to do, it's going to be even more of a crackdown. Quote, this is from Klaus Schwab, the founder and executive chairman of the World Economic Forum. Quote, every country from the United States to China must participate, and every industry from oil and gas to tech must be transformed. He added, quote, in short, we need a great reset of capitalism. Schwab said that, quote, all aspects of our societies and economies, from education to social contracts and working conditions, must be revamped. So
when they put this in place, whatever great things they say they're going to do, whether it's a UBI or, you know, sort of standardized working conditions, worldwide unions, whatever it is that they're doing, mm-hmm. You can be sure that the social order, the economic strata, the quintiles, the economic quintiles, the amounts that people make and have. Because currently here in the United States, people move up and they move down all the time. They would love you to believe in the press that this is not true. But, I mean, Walmart didn't exist when I was born. Mm-hmm. And the big retailers, the big retailers were completely different. Amazon didn't exist. The mm-hmm. biggest companies that we have today, Google, didn't exist. The biggest companies we have today.
Yeah, it was Woolworths back then, right?
Just didn't exist. Yeah. The things change in a country that has more freedom versus the ones that have fewer economic mm-hmm. freedoms. What they're trying to do is make by, they're dangling the carrot out there. You'll never be poor again. As if anybody in the Western world is starving to death. Mm-hmm. Are people in the rest of the world starving to death? Yes, we need to figure out ways to get them. But most people who are starving to death in the last 50 years have starved to death having to do with their governments, mm-hmm. Not having to do with actual famines.
I want to bring Connie on the line in Huntsville, Alabama, listening to WBHP. Go ahead, Connie.
Yes, what you're talking about is the New World Order, the Bill Gates, the Rothschilds, the Bilderbergers, the Rockefellers. What they're doing, when they had the World Forum meeting in France, French president has always given the speech. Well, he didn't this time. Prince Charles did, and they rant and raved how great he was. He is going to be the next leader of the world, the Antichrist.
He's going to be king of England at some point, right? I mean, his mother's, God bless her, is going to pass away at some point. So.
Well, I'm not talking about just England. I'm talking about the New World Order. He's going to be in charge of it. That's who they'll elect.
Now, are you saying that you think there's going to be a world government that comes out of this?
Yes, that's what the whole New World Order is.
Well, I know that's what they've been saying for the longest time, but the reason that part's hard for me to believe is because most of these politicians don't want to give up power. You know, Donald Trump doesn't want Prince Charles telling him what to do.
Mm-hmm. No, he wouldn't. But all these people, they have powers. They can do whatever they want to. Bill Gates, he was donating vaccines to India. Well, they were contaminated, and they had so many people that were so deformed, he got booted out of India. They don't want him there. And then down like in one of the countries of Africa, they were giving vaccines to all the girls there, and it was sterilizing them. They want to reduce the amount of people dependent. And then they want all of us to be dependent on them so they can be, and rule the whole world.
That much is true. They definitely want more people to be dependent on them, whoever they are, meaning government goons all across the world. And Connie, thank you for the call tonight. I do appreciate hearing from you. That is the one thing that the New World Order promoters have been, talking about, that it's going to be a world government. It just seems so hard to believe that they could pull that off, given that government people are power seekers and they're not power releasers. They don't want to let go. I mean, you know, Venezuela's Maduro doesn't, I mean, he wants handouts, but he doesn't want to give up his control over the people there. You know, Trump doesn't want to give up control. The people in Congress certainly don't want to give up their level of power. So I don't see that one happening. But then again, who saw this one coming?
I think that the seeking for the politicians seeking power, you know, rent seeking behavior, as they call it, is part of the thing that stands in the way of an actual world government.
That's what I was saying.
Absolutely. And it's one of the difficulties of it is imagine you set up a world, like imagine the United States federal government, which was intended to actually be an overlay of governments, right? It's the states are called states for a reason. A state is defined as an organization that claims a monopoly privilege over the given landmass, the use of violence. So the federal government could have gone all over the world, but it couldn't keep its little greedy little fingers from using the interstate commerce clause and the general welfare clause for getting involved in everything that's going on. Mm-hmm. If the federal government just said, all right, everybody's got to have a standardized weights and measures, Jesus, should be metric, and everybody's got to drive on the right-hand side of the road, and this is the military for anybody who signs up, and you've got to allow people to move inside the general federal area, it'd basically be the EU, right? Like EU was kind of the Schengen zone is sort of like this. A government could be, a world government could be possible, but the problem of it is that the politicians don't want to let go of power.
Right.
Because an overlay that just allows people to travel and do business inside without all these sort of weird rules that import-export laws and all that sort of thing, that's what people want.
I think the problem with the idea of a world government, too, is that it gives people something to point at and be like, well, there's the cause of all our problems, right? If you're actually in charge. And the other thing, Prince Charles is probably just a front man, right? Like, he might be involved in stuff, but, like, if you're actually in charge of how the world is running, right? Like, say, what these people want is they want control over your money. And they want control over how the economy operates and how it's ran. They want to regulate that. They don't want a government.
855-450-FREE. The good news is if you put your money into things like cryptocurrency, then they don't have control over it.
Mm-hmm. They don't like that much either.
If you pick the right ones, for instance, like Monero, for instance, which is a privacy coin. 855-450-FREE, like freedom. You can join us here. This is Free Talk Live.
Have you ever thought about turning your Glock, XD family, or 1911 handgun into a semi-automatic carbine? It only takes about 30 seconds. The MechTech Carbine Upper is classified as an accessory and can be delivered right to your doorstep with no FFL or background check required. It's the world's most versatile pistol accessory. Build your custom upper today. Simply go to handgunconversion.com. That's handgunconversion.com.
Are you ready for what's next? It's likely coming. More food shortages, power outages, grocery stores closed, social unrest. Ask yourself, do you have enough food and supplies on hand to last at least 30 days? Most Americans do not, but you can. Avoid the panic of the last-minute rush. Order your 4-week supply of emergency food today from MyPatriotSupply.com. Starvation or dependency on the government are your only alternatives. Avoid those and the pain of being unprepared. Go to MyPatriotSupply.com right now. Build your emergency food supply with meals that last up to 25 years in storage, shipped discreetly to your door. Folks that know what's coming are using today to prepare. There's time for you to do the same. That's MyPatriotSupply.com, the original Patriot Preparedness Company. MyPatriotSupply.com.
Silver has always been nature's very own antibiotic, and only one system allows you to generate an endless supply of natural silver solutions, SilverLungs.com. You'll find no wild claims or pseudoscience, just a lifetime of nano-sized pure silver solutions. The Silver Lungs generator allows you to make your own, so stop paying for silver solutions. The unique lung delivery system targets respiratory infections where other silver solutions simply cannot reach. See the Silver Lungs generator and lung delivery system at SilverLungs.com. That's SilverLungs.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of
where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of Liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. When you amp Free Talk Live, you get perks like access to the AMP only Facebook group and AMP podcast. Visit amp.freetalklive.com. What if you want to hear the latest episode of Free Talk Live, but all you have is your phone, you forgot to download our archive, and you have no data connection? You can call our listen line at 641-793-0191. That's a long-distance number, so you may incur charges. If not, listen as long as you want. 641-793-0191. The Free Talk Live listen line, 641-793-0191.
Are you tired of governments around the world killing innocent people? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin is money that cannot be inflated or controlled by any state. By continuing to use their money, you're perpetuating the killing. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available to you now. Learn it, use it, spread it.
Get started with Bitcoin at Bitcoin.com. It's Bitcoin.com.
You're listening to the best Liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Yeah, it's Free Talk Live. You bring up anything you want here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE like freedom. Thanks to Bitcoin.com for being longtime. Epic level sponsor here on Free Talk Live. Thank you guys, because there's amazing stuff over at Bitcoin.com, including a nice introductory section where you can learn about Bitcoin and Bitcoin Cash, cryptocurrency in general. There's no better time than now when they're starting to put a so-called great reset into place, and they're going to be doing even more damage to world economies and money supplies and things like that. Now's the time to start learning about your other options, and Bitcoin.com is a great place to go and do that. By the way, I also want to say thanks to Doug, who is a Free Talk Live silver amplifier, and Ron Pepper, who's a gold amplifier. These guys are helping and amp the show, which means advertise, market, and promote. They're helping us get Free Talk Live on more radio stations around the United States to bring the ideas of freedom and liberty to as many ears as we possibly can, while we still can, because at least in this country, you can still criticize the government for the moment. So we will continue to do that. The government gang.
We're good at it. We've been doing it for a long time.
Yeah, we're going to continue. Ian Tyler and Mark in the studio. Let's go to your phone calls and thoughts. Jack is in Chattanooga, Tennessee, listening to WGOW on FM. Go ahead, Jack.
How you doing, guys?
Welcome, sir.
I wanted to talk about the Great Reset.
Yeah, scary stuff.
The only thing we can't agree on between, you know, left, right, and anybody else, whatever, is that we do need a Great Reset now. Whether the freedom they take away or they give, that's the conversation we should be having. But I think you guys would agree that we also need a great reset from the current state of things. Like,
I'd say so. It's the people that...
24-hour news cycle garbage. Yeah. I would reset social media. I would reset so many other things that really are a poison to so much.
Yeah, I think that all sides can sort of agree on is that the global elite, as they're called, and they must exist, right? There are people out there that have a great deal of money that are seeking power.
They're the World Economic Forum,
probably a few other organizations too, perhaps competing, perhaps cooperative. That these people are out of touch with us, not interested in providing us with what it is that we really want, what we really need in life, and that whatever they do that qualifies as a great reset will likely be, and this is a point that I didn't get to make previously, will make it less easy to move between economic strata. So the people who are in the bottom quintile of earners globally are more likely to stay there after this global reset. And those that are in the top are more likely to be there too.
Permapoor.
Gotcha. Well, okay, I got you. So it's basically instead of resetting, it's basically a cementing of the status quo.
Well, the people who are going to be making these decisions are rich and powerful. I suspect they aren't going to walk out in sackcloth and ashes.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, what the rich and powerful you've been able to count on, you've been able to count on the rich and powerful to do for 9,000 years of the agricultural revolution that we've had here is to hold on to their wealth and their power.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's what you can count on.
They're still going to have a luxury lifestyle when their little reset is over, and the rest of us, they don't care.
Yeah, I don't.
This isn't a real reset. Like, an honest reset would be, you know, governments collapsing and people coming together and creating something new. What this is like, all of a sudden we're going to change the board and we're going to change the way the money looks, but the banker is still going to be the banker.
That's right.
And we're still going to be running around the board trying to collect our $200.
Yeah, that's a great analogy.
The banker is going to decide that $200 is too much and you're just going to get $100 now. Uh-huh. The banker sets the rules.
No, now it's $2,000, Mark. They added a zero.
Sure, but there's 10 times as much money, or there's 20 times as much money.
Jack, thanks for the call tonight,
great
man.
Show,
I appreciate
guys.
It. Yep, and you enjoy that ride out there. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
Yeah, this is kind of something we were talking about in the break, and something that I will never understand is that, ladies and gentlemen, think about that amount of money to you that is sort of that the amount of money that you would have to have freedom for the rest of your life, whatever that amount is. I like to use the number $5 million. Because that seems like a lot of money to me.
It's an amount that the average person is probably never going to come close to.
Right. Mm-hmm. So if you have $5 million, you can probably not work. You can buy the house you want to buy in all likelihood. I mean, you're not going to have a mansion in Beverly Hills, but who the hell wants to live there? You're going to have the things you need, and $5 million, presumably you can invest in some manner or another to be able to live the rest of your life without having to do X. And you want to have some things that keep you busy in life. But these people have factors more money than this.
Mm-hmm.
So you're talking about $50 million. Now, what's the difference between the lifestyle of having $5 million and $50 million? I suppose you can live in the zip code that you want to live, the very best zip code, if you have $50 million, and then invest the money and then not have to worry about life and those sorts of things. You'll with any of these, by the way, once you stop having to work, I shudder to think what it does to, I shudder to think what it would do to me.
Yeah.
If I didn't have to work, then what would I do? Well, probably nothing good.
Let's go to Mortified Penguin. He's on the line in Virginia. Go ahead, Mortified Penguin.
Yeah, I'm glad to hear you guys talking about this. What I wanted to bring up was the exact opposite of a world order, new or otherwise. Basically, there's, you know, when you start diving into libertarian kind of ideas and theories and anarchist ideas and theories, and you run into all these different hyphenations and groups and designations and theories, and it's very adolescent. You have all these little denominations and terminology, and it's very simple. What is libertarianism? What is anarchist or anarchist leaning libertarian, especially, it's just very simply a different view of human relations based on a lack of domination of other people, a lack of planning of people, basically other than yourselves and those you're interacting with, basically a lack of domination, and a lot of people say coercion, in other people. And it's just a different mindset of human relations, and any kind of ideas or theories, especially those that are like prescriptivist.
I don't think it's a different mindset. I think most humans interact with one another in a non-aggressive manner. That's why it is we have a peaceful society, because most people understand that we don't get anywhere as a society by bashing each other over the head and taking
or even
things.
Being mean.
Right. So I think that libertarianism is something that is inherently understood, at least on a personal level, by people, but they don't understand how it applies on a national, the idea of justifying violence for all of these concepts that they want to impose. So they get it person to person. They would never, unless they're a psychopath, put a gun to their neighbor's head and demand that they do a thing. But they don't have any objection to voting and forcing their neighbors to do anything.
That's a great point. And I mean, that's basically, I agree with that. I'd counter by looking at it. Well, no, I mean, I'm basically agreeing with you that, yeah, so on a peer-to-peer level, I mean, people aren't trying to dominate their peers, but it's the lack of an you know, organizing principles based of society, you know, based on domination. So it's not accepting it peer-to-peer and not accepting it from above or demanding it from above and not, you know, wanting it on other people and realizing that order, that, you know, it's said that order doesn't bring liberty, but liberty is the mother of order. So, you know, freedom brings a sort of order. It's not anarchy as in chaos.
Well, there's such a thing as a natural order, right? So, like,
spontaneous order.
You can see this in patterns in nature, for instance. There's a lot of evidence for it out there. And thank you for the call tonight, Mortified Penguin. I definitely appreciate it.
Yeah, I don't think it's a different state of mind, but it's definitely a different paradigm, right? Like, libertarians are the ones that, instead of looking at things from a left-right paradigm, they look at it from a liberty versus authority paradigm. Mm-hmm. And it's that idea that it's like these lessons that we learned as kids, we try and apply them in real life as we become adults. And a lot of people get conditioned to thinking that authority is okay, right? Like, I don't like to call myself an anarchist because I'm not sure if I believe that fully, and I don't like to call myself a libertarian.
I would
an
never
anarchist.
Use that term to describe myself.
Yeah, it doesn't suit me. But what does suit me, one thing I can say with full conviction, is I'm a voluntarist.
Me too.
Right? Yep. Everything has to be done in a voluntary, consensual manner, and I don't think that's how do you even argue against that?
It's very hard. Yeah. I mean, the arguments against it usually involve somebody saying they don't think people can make decisions for themselves and they
right.
need to be told what to do.
Mm-hmm. It's that
total,
like,
total authoritarianism.
Right. Father knows best kind of mentality. Mm-hmm. These people that think that they ought to do things on your behalf because you're not capable of doing it.
That's really what those folks, a lot of them, believe.
Yeah.
That they know. They're smart enough.
They
the
know
rest of those
best.
People know. They need to be told.
Yeah, most people prefer a voluntary interaction, which they in their mind means people voluntarily doing what they wish that those people would do. Mm-hmm. And that's not voluntarism.
It's like, yeah, it's like that old jingoistic notion from like the 1800s of the white man's burden, right? That Europe was supposed to civilize the world.
Yeah.
Now you've got leftists that are like, oh, we need to civilize all of these non-mask wearers and get them in line and get everybody to conform. And it's ridiculous.
Yep, it is. And we're out of time for tonight, but you can join us between now and tomorrow night's show because we're here all 7 nights a week, so don't miss a moment. But if you want to, you can join us online anytime you want over at freetalklive.com. Grab archives, get interactive on our Discord server, and more. It's freetalklive.com.
Remember when you first heard about Bitcoin? How long did it take you to realize this little project would soon change the world? Do you kind of wish you had gotten involved sooner? Well, now is your chance to be a part of the next revolution in money. Intercoin is working to finally make crypto go mainstream. It's designed to be scalable enough to support everyday payments and even elections without the state. Bitcoin was originally supposed to be a peer-to-peer cash system, the way we would all pay one another without having to trust any third party. But instead, over time, it mostly became a store of value. That's because every 10 minutes, the Bitcoin network must put all transactions into a block, and that block can only hold so much. If crypto is to become mainstream for people to use it for everyday payments, we need a new architecture, one that is as secure as Bitcoin while being far more scalable. Check out intercoin.org to find out more and maybe pick up some of those coins for yourself.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com. Some of you asked, and now we've delivered. LRN.FM's live Keene, New Hampshire studio shows are now streamed in HD on Twitch. Visit our channel at twitch.lrn.fm and give it a follow. If you have Amazon Prime, you get one free subscription on Twitch. If you use it on our channel, Twitch will give LRN.FM a monthly piece of your Prime subscription cost. So please watch, follow, share, and subscribe to twitch.lrn.fm. That's twitch.lrn.fm.
The latest episode of Declare Your Independence with Ernest Hancock is next after the news on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is a Fox News alert. It all comes down to this. I'm Lisa LaSera. The final night of the Democratic National Convention, all about the top of the ticket.
Tonight, the Democrats' focus is on one man, Joe Biden. He will accept the party nomination in his home city of Wilmington, Delaware. Before he lays out what he sees as America's promise, which is also the final night's theme, speeches from Senators Tammy Duckworth and Cory Booker will be heard, as well as words from former mayors Pete Buttigieg of South Bend, Indiana, and Mike Bloomberg of New York City. Also, a tribute will be presented honoring the life and legacy of Congressman John Lewis, who passed away in July. After tonight, 73 days will remain before Election Day. Gernal Scott, Fox News.
Fox News Radio's Democracy 2020 coverage of the Democratic National Convention is now live. Download the Fox News app. Click listen to listen live. President Trump took his campaign to Joe Biden's birthplace this afternoon, just outside Scranton, Pennsylvania, with this to say about his opponent's nominating speech.
He's going to make a speech tonight. It's going to be very interesting to see how he does. And I hope he does well. I'll be honest, I do. I hope he does well. I really hope he does well. But I also want him to tell the truth. He's got to tell the truth about things, and he's going to do a lot better if he does, but hopefully not well enough.
But the president warned the crowd Biden wants to create a permanent lockdown and a socialist takeover. Attorney General William Barr says the Justice Department will seek to reinstate the death sentence of Boston Marathon bomber Jokhar Tsarnaev. Barr told the AP the Justice Department will appeal last month's court decision, which tossed the death sentence and ordered a new trial to determine if he should be executed for the 2013 attack that killed three and wounded more than 260 others. America is listening to Fox News.
Who knew that the same company that made the twist ties around your loaf of bread also made the face shield delivered to your front door? Packaging solutions provider Bedford Industries stepped up in a big way during the pandemic with help from NetSuite, the world's number one cloud business system. Here's Bedford's president, Jay Milbrandt.
At Bedford, we saw an opportunity to retool our products to create face shields. Thanks to the visibility and control NetSuite provides, we had the agility to change our business overnight. In no time, NetSuite helped us launch our first e-commerce site and handled crucial details from licensing to order tracking. Now we're taking orders from around the world, 24/7. We couldn't have done it without NetSuite.
NetSuite by Oracle gives you visibility and control over your financials, HR, inventory, e-commerce, and more. Everything you need all in one place. They surveyed hundreds of business leaders and assembled a playbook of top strategies they're using as America reopens for business. Receive your free guide, 7 actions businesses need to take now, and schedule your free product tour at netsuite.com/fox. netsuite.com/fox.
More than two dozen major fires continue to burn in California, including the LNU complex fire in Napa and Sonoma.
We do have over 30,000 structures that are threatened. We do have 105 confirmed structures destroyed and 70 confirmed structures that are damaged within the entire complex.
CAL FIRE spokesman Jeremy Ron, the fires are largely blamed on a lightning storm that weather forecasters are calling unprecedented. Fires are also burning in the Sierra Nevada and Southern California wildlands. A sixth lawsuit has been filed involving the sudden deaths of patients at a West Virginia VA hospital where a former nursing assistant admitted to killing 7 people with fatal doses of insulin. The federal lawsuit filed in the 2018 death of Russell Posey Sr., who was in the Lewis A. Johnson Medical Center in Clarksburg. Fired hospital nursing assistant Retta Mays pled guilty last month to intentionally killing 7 patients with wrongful insulin injections. She faces up to life in prison for each of 7 counts of second-degree murder. If you filed your 2019 federal income tax returns on time, you could get money from the IRS soon.
IRS and the Treasury Department say they're sending interest payments to more than 13 million taxpayers who are receiving refunds this year. Settle down, you haven't hit the lottery. The IRS says the average payment will be about $18. In a statement, the IRS says in most cases, taxpayers who receive their refund by direct deposit will have their interest payment direct deposited in the same account. Everyone else will get a regular check in the mail. The IRS says these interest payments are taxable, and taxpayers who get them must report the interest on the 2020 federal income tax return they file next year. Tanya J. Powers, Fox News.
Wall Street, the Dow added 46. I'm Lee Silasera. This is Fox News.
In Baltimore, the streets have gotten safer thanks to the success of the new permanent daylight initiative, which aims to prevent crime by illuminating the entire city 24 hours a day using high-powered floodlights.
It's just that it's so bright all the time.